Okay.
I had someone videotape me one time while I was in Portland, and they did like an 8-hour class, and they videotaped all 8 hours, and I was like, I'd love to see what this looks like. I took the camera off one time, and I took it around. It was fantastic. Unfortunately, you guys have stopped me from doing that.
Yeah.
Another one, I just, it's great. Yeah. It's like ballet service.
That's the bathroom.
Oh, I scattered it out. Don't you worry about that.
Hey, okay, we're ready.
We didn't lose too many people. We're doing pretty good. I'm scared. My throat's starting to hurt.
Are they sugar-free?
I don't think so. Are the sugar-free ones the bad ones?
Yeah, the sugar-free ones are the bad ones. It's the fake sugar that'll mess with your
skin. Oh, yeah. No, you don't mess around with that stuff.
You got real sugar, you're good. You'll just be, you know, bouncing off the wall.
Sorry, I got to send one text real quick. I had to send it to my wife, letting her know that there's a picture of me holding a goat. She missed out on it. She just sent back a text and said, what? With a bunch of
exes.
That's awesome. It's a I feel like so out of towner saying like, there's a goat. I don't know. There's a goat. I didn't ask questions. I looked at the goat. Right? Whoa, we've gotten an extra one. Oh. I was going to say we had one extra email that hadn't been answered.
Oh,
oh, was it? What are you doing today? You put it on YouTube?
Well, yeah, it's a live stream. What? Have you done Google Hangouts on there yet?
I actually haven't.
You can live stream it on YouTube.
What? Well, guys, I'd like to say it was a pleasure working with everyone. Monday will probably be out of business. Funny. Some people always ask me, like, are you a KW like approved vendor or anything? I said, we contacted about it a while back. I never did anything with it, but I was like, I feel like there's a good amount of guidelines I'd have to go by. And I'm a wild card. So it's I like being the wild card. Cool. How was lunch? Someone said thank you. I did not purchase it for you, but I appreciate that you thought I did. Also, I'm glad. Did anyone get a good fortune?
No.
Is it really? This is a weird one. It just says, get the class started, you idiot. That's weird. I don't know why.
I was concerned about having it tell me I needed a hobby, but I love that. Vlogging will be my new hobby.
Boom.
We're just counting seconds. Very good. All right. So in this second class today, we're going to chat about blogging. You just said you were excited about it. All right. There you go. Oh, there you go. Well, in addition to blogging, we're also going to chat about adding pages because we didn't get to do it in the first class, but this will kind of go hand in hand with the blogging because having custom content on this new website is going to help you out tremendously. So if you recall before, I said the new website is SEO friendly for search engine optimization. That's why we went in and we set up Google Analytics. 92% of the class we were able to set up the webmaster tools too. So hopefully we'll get up to 100% soon. All right, and then obviously having the custom domain will help out tremendously too. Having all that set up is fantastic, but if you don't have quality content on your website, Google's not going to really do anything for you. All right, so blogging is going to help out tremendously. I always kind of get the question of how often should I blog? And there's not really a definite answer. If you want to blog once a day, so you're going to do 7 times a week, that's awesome. That is phenomenal. That's more than I do. I don't do any. Someone does it for me, I guess. I don't know. I just kind of look and it's done. If you want to blog 5 times a week, maybe Monday to Friday, that's fantastic. All right, 3 times is kind of the average if you can do that. All right, if you can only blog once a week, that's still one more time than other people are. All right, so as long as you're creating some type of blog, that's fantastic. All right. So with that being said, having quality content is going to help you out tremendously. Typically, if you guys are writing some stuff down before we start, usually for blogs, you want to keep it at the bare minimum 300 words, right? At the least. Typically in 2016, having longer blogs will help you out a little bit more. All right, so you can make it 600, 900, 1,200 words. I don't know why I went up by 30s, but anyway. All right, that'll be fantastic. And typically, if you're trying to rank for a specific keyword, all right, the longer tail keywords, the better, and a long tail keyword is one that's a little bit lengthier. All right, so if you look for Idaho real estate, not exactly long tail, probably a lot of people are going after that, including some big name companies that start with a Z and a T. Zillow and Trulia. Okay, cool. Just want to make sure. All right. So, but if you look for Idaho real estate for sale in Idaho Falls, all right, that's an extremely lengthy keyword. Search around, see what people are looking for. All right, you can actually go to Google AdWords and utilize the keyword tool, right, to see how often someone is searching for a phrase. It's interesting. I'll have people contact all the time. They say, I'm on the first page of Google, and you want to be on the first page of Google. Because if you're on the second page of Google, you don't really exist. So you want to be on that first page. And they say, I'm on the first page of Google. I'm number one or two for about 300 different keywords. I said, that's awesome. How much traffic did you get last month? And they'll say, about 200, 300 visitors. I'm like, well, what keywords are you going after? So make sure you're going after keywords that you really want to rank for and that people are actually searching for. You could be number one on Google for a keyword that no one's ever going to see. And that's awesome. But at the end of the day, being number one on Google isn't going to pay the bills. All right, it's definitely not going to bring in buyers or sellers. All right, so we want to make sure that we're being found properly.
Where did you say you find the keywords?
Mm-hmm.
On Google?
Yes, there's the keyword tool. I'm just going to search for this real quick. Yep. So it's adwords.google.com/keyword planner. And that way you can actually see what people are searching for. And they'll give you suggestions as well. So if you type in Idaho real estate, it'll probably say Idaho real estate for sale by owner, Idaho homes for sale. All right, it'll give you different suggestions on that. And you can see the competition. It'll have it at low, moderate, or high. And it'll show how many monthly views you get. You won't be able to sign into AdWords from your katie.com email, FYI. It'll have to be from a Gmail account. All right, so make sure you're using a Gmail account. If you don't own a Gmail account, it's free. All right, so just go to gmail.com and sign right up. All right, and the other thing to note is whatever keyword you are searching for, all right, you can add it into your content about 1% to 3% of the time is usually the going rate. All right, so say if you're doing a 600-word blog, if you add it in 1% of the time to be, you know, a little bit more conservative, then that'll be about 6 times. All right, or if you're doing it 3 times, then that'd be about 18. All right, and typically you want to try and get that keyword over inside your slug URL that we'll take a look at, your title, and then also over in that meta title and meta description. All right, I think you guys are already back over here. I don't know why I'm starting back from the beginning. But let's get back to the back end of our Playster site real quick. Everyone's quieted down.
Sugar.
How's that say? Sugar. Yeah, lunch came through. All right, so I'm going to go back over our Playster website. All right, one more. Oh, that's right.
That's what we all got.
Mine should definitely do that. I need to log into mine. I forgot. Sorry about that. All right, so pop quiz from the first class. All right, for the photos on the slideshow. All right, what are the dimensions we're looking at?
1600 by 666.
There you go. Not 16? Cool. All right. Okay, cool, cool. Just make sure.
Does it matter if they're labeled? Does that change the search engine optimization?
It will help. Yeah, if you do happen to have those on it, yeah. Okay, another thing. Let's get over.
Another one.
You guys passed. There you go. I can't remember the other one to ask. All right, so let's go back to the Playster homepage. Now, if you're on here and you're under site settings, all right, fantastic. And we're going to click on blog post at the top of here so we can actually add inside some blog posts. Now, every site that comes out from Playster is going to have 4 generic blog posts on there. All right, so you're going to have generic content already on there. All right, the faster that you can replace them, all right, the better. Because right, obviously, if 129,000, is that how many KW agents there are?
141.
That's a real trend. That's a lot. All right. No one's a lip reader in here.
Nope,
no, that's
not
right.
At all.
That's a lot. Yeah, so if 141, mm-hmm. All right, have the exact same, you know, post on there, that's probably not going to help you out too much. So the faster we can get rid of these and replace them, the better. All right, so let's click on blog post real quick. It's going to bug me. I can't remember what that other thing was.
The meta
Yeah, you're right. Thanks.
So 55 and 155, by the way.
There you go. Thank you.
You're welcome. Here to help.
All right, so once we go back to our blog post, here are the four generic blog posts I was talking about on here. So before we remove them, let's just leave them on here, because what I've typically told people is you're going to have four that I'll actually display on your homepage. If you want to look at your homepage, you can actually see what this will look like. So if I just pop this up, if you guys just want to watch real quick, that's cool. That works. All right, so if I scroll down, I also have a testimonial on here. You're going to have four different blog posts on the homepage. So if you want to leave those on just so you have some content right now, so it doesn't look sporadic, that's perfectly fine. And then slowly start to replace them. Because this big one right here is actually going to be your most recent one. And what they're looking at. But that's I love stock photos. On your homepage? All right. Well, once you're back on the blog, though, let's go and click edit. You can click edit on any of them. I'm going to click on the 5 tips for buying a home All right, so I'm going to click on edit on here. Obviously, if you want to remove them later on, you can. All right, so let's just take a look at what we need to add inside, and then we'll add one in a second, too. All right, so we're looking down here on our title. This can be whatever title you want to add in. All right, now, much like your meta title, I'll try to keep it short and sweet. All right, in fact, if you want this title to match your meta title, go for it. All right, so under how many characters?
55.
There you go, 55. It's 55. All right, but if you look at something, whenever you add inside the title on here, so they have 5 tips for buying a home. All right, then it's going to have your site domain on here. All right, and since I have the custom URL, it's not showing it on here, but mine would come up as scottleroy.com/5-tips-4-buying-a-home. Now, having dashes or hyphens between each word will help out tremendously for SEO. All right, so if you ever look, you guys ever taking that 3-hour class that I do, when we talk about the profile, we say put a hyphen between your name on the profile. It'll help you out for SEO. All right, same scenario here, except it automatically does it for you, which is the good part about it. So if I come back up here, I'm typing Scott LeRoy, it puts dashes between everything. All right, so no matter what you put inside here, it's automatically going to do that for you. Nope. Wrong button. All right, now for the content down here, this is where you can add inside, well, whatever you want your blog to look like. Mm-hmm. Now, we don't have too much as far as you can change colors or anything of that sort. You can really just kind of bold, italicize, underline up here. If you want to add inside lists or numbers, you're welcome to as well. You can even hyperlink items, which we'll do all of this today. All right, but there is a formatting option where you can change from normal text to quote, header 3, header 4. So we'll add inside a couple different headers on here. All right, and for those that are big into YouTube or listing videos, I know you said earlier you had a listing video. Maybe you want to make a blog on it. All right, so there is an option. And I don't know why I'm talking about the images. There's an option to insert a video on here too. So if I click insert video, you can either put inside the embed code or a YouTube Vimeo link. And we'll actually go and get that and copy it over here too, show you how easy to add inside. All right, so the other real big question that everyone always asks is, and there is a section on here for images. Now, anyone that's worked with the eEdge website or even the eAgency website, you kind of have to upload them first, and then you can move them over. And on the eEdge, it's a little bit harder because you have to get that URL. On here, you literally just upload it, and you're done. All right, so it makes it a little bit easier for you. All right, one of the other big questions we always get is, I want a blog, but I don't know what to blog on. All right, so you might have a little bit of a writer's block. One thing you can always do, blog on any of your listings that you have. If you have a listing video, pull it out, and then you write 300, 400, 500 words on it. All right, hyperlink it back over where they can actually view the listing. All right, if you happen to have a new listing coming in, or you just want to blog on the area as well, maybe something new is developing around here. All right, or if you just get writer's block, search KCM, Zillow blog, Trulia blog, realtor.com advice. See what other people are writing about, get an idea from there, and then create your own. So don't copy everything that someone's writing, obviously, but get an idea as to what they're writing about too. All right, we are actually going to do this in a second too. I just want you to see what it'll look like. Now there's a section down here for excerpts. All right, and whatever you put inside here will actually display back out here. All right, so they don't have anything, so that's why they have the dot, dot, dots at the bottom, the little ellipses. All right, so on here you just put a little piece about what this blog is about. Kind of like in our meta description, when we talk about what the page is about to get them to click over, this will be kind of similar on here. So if you want to, you can leave a blank if you want it to look like this, where it'll just have a dot, dot, dot. There's nothing wrong with that. Right? Or you can just take a couple of different sentences, add it over. All right, and then the featured image will display over here as well. All right, so we do want to have an image on here. I want to make sure we have one.
If you do a video, will the video be the thumbnail there?
Not on the featured image, unfortunately.
We have to have a featured image.
Yes. Yeah. All right, and then if we scroll down, then as we saw before, you have meta title and meta description. All right, and you'll see them on the far right side where you can actually see what they want you to say within. All right, so let's do one. Let's hop back over, click on that blog post again, and we'll click the plus sign. All right, anytime you ever see a plus sign, that means you're going to add something. It's so quiet in here. Your pin drop. It happens every time after lunch.
All the troublemakers left.
Oh, did they?
I didn't.
It's so funny. After lunch, everyone eats, and then everyone just gets crazy tired. I'm like, yes. Look at that. That's it. I spent 7 months on a boat going in circles. I prepped for this. I'm ready. Jungle Cruise. How's your skipper, man? Skipper, lion tamer, boat driver. If you don't laugh at my jokes, swimming instructor. That's right. One person got that. Thank you. No one else used to laugh at it anyway. So whatever. 2009 is the new 2016. All right. So once we click on the plus sign on here, we have where we can actually post our content. All right. So now we need to make whatever blog we want to. All right, so on here, you don't have to make a blog if you don't want to. Obviously, we're just going to go through and see how we can do it. All right, so for the title, feel free to type inside whatever you want to. Did I type it all right? No. Close. I'll take it. All right, now if you can keep the title a little lower, there's not exactly a limitation on this, unlike on search engines, where it's going to cut it off typically around the 55 or 60 character mark. On the title, I mean, you could technically make it as long as you want to, usually having a short and sweet one. It's fantastic. So my keyword I'm actually going to go for today is Scott LeRoy Marketing East Idaho Class. Now, if you can put your keyword inside the title, that's phenomenal. All right, that is fantastic. All right, if you can't, don't worry about it. You want to make sure that your content sounds authentic. You want to make sure that it flows. It's interesting. We have someone on our staff that loves writing. She travels all the time. She just got off of like a 2-month travel through like Europe. Loves writing blogs everywhere. And I told her, I was like, cool, do you want to write some of these blogs? And she did. I said, awesome. So this is kind of how we have to write it. And she said, this is hard. I was like, yeah, it's not as free form. You kind of have to put inside those keywords on here. So if it doesn't sound correct, if you're reading it and it sounds like a computer wrote it, all right, maybe you want to change it a little bit around there. All right, now what I'm gonna, it didn't work with what I thought it was gonna do. Awesome. So once I have the title, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna paste it over inside my content. All right, so once you have your title, you guys can do this too. If you want to. No. I'm going to watch that screen. You did it. All right. That works. Okay. That's true. All right. So once you highlight it, then I'm actually going to reformat it. And I kind of like header 4 a little bit better than header 3. It looks a little bit cleaner. All right. So I'm going to make it my header on here.
I was letting them know, hey, this is what I'm going for. My keywords over inside my header.
Hey, do what you gotta do, man. Summer activities. And once we're done with this blog, too, if you guys do want to write something down, I see some people that are actually writing on here. That's good. If you would like to recite what you wrote.
I'm writing about lava hot springs.
Lava hot springs. Sounds like a resort pool and spa, is it?
It kind of is.
That's
one place you should actually go, is to the hot springs.
The hot springs.
It's actually an actual, it's not like hike up in the mountains.
You guys ever seen Captain America Winter Soldier?
Yeah.
When he like pulls out the list and he's like, I'll put it on my list. That's what I feel like today. I'm a big superhero fan. If you want to talk superhero stuff, let me know. All right. So you said hot springs?
Lava hot springs.
All right. My apologies. All right. I'm just going to jot this down over here. Cool. We're going to remember that because that sounds cool. All right. Now, once we add inside our header on here, I'm going to go back over. I'm going to go to the normal text. All right. Then you can start typing inside whatever you want today. All right.
I'm supposed to type it in. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yes, I got it.
Yeah.
I
you're going. No, don't worry about it. So on here, then you start to type whatever you want to. It's got LeRoy Marketing. I need to stop typing like that. He's very excited and proud to be a part. I only messed up like 8 words. That's good. Spell check, it's your friend. All right, start typing inside whatever you want to on here. All right, typically per each paragraph, at least 3 sentences. We're going back to first grade grammar.
I see a lot of people with 2 sentence paragraphs.
I don't think I can really talk about grammar and then say, don't be doing that. That ain't good. All right, now whenever you need to start a new paragraph, all right, so say we have finished our thought on this. All right, obviously this is a very generic one on here, but if I finish my thought, say I'm breaking it down into different sections. Or maybe, for instance, you're doing the top 5 things to do in
Lava Hot Springs.
All right, then maybe I want to put right over here, numero uno, visit Lava Hot Springs. All right, now if you ever add anything inside, I do suggest bolding it. All right, so highlight and click the bold button. All right, so then you kind of right here. Here's my new train of thought. All right, so when someone's reading this, they kind of see, here are the different sections that I might want to take a look at. All right, because at the end of the day, if anyone reads this blog, that's fantastic. There's a chance that no one's going to read it.
What?
Jessica will read everyone's blog. Everyone. You post them today. Send them. Post the blog. Send Jessica a URL that just says, Scott said you have to read this for homework. And then just the URL on there.
I just stopped typing. Nobody's
going to
read it,
huh? Just, the class is over. No one's going to read these. Yeah. All right. So there's a chance that no one might read it. All right. Someone's going to read it. You'll read it. So one person will read it. The main thing we want, though, is for the search engines to read this. So let's make sure that they can find it. All right, so adding inside a couple items on here is going to help out tremendously. Now, once again, when we put inside our title down here, you can put inside your keyword. And I said, mine's going to be Seller Marketing East Idaho Class. And it's fantastic if you can include it over inside the title. And then we'll put it right over here in our header. And then if you include it as well over inside that first paragraph, that'd be fantastic. I remember, what's the percentage per each word that you can have the keyword?
1 to 3.
Yeah.
So you just pick a keyword and click one keyword?
You'll pick one keyword to focus on for this blog, and then each blog it'll be a different keyword. All right, now if I'm gonna go through, say I don't know anything about Lava Hot Springs, because I don't. All right, so if I wanna go through here and I actually wanna add inside an image instead, all right, now you guys are writing. All right, I'm going to click on the upload image option on here.
I mean, add whatever image you want to, as long as you have rights to it. Now, remember, once again, you can also go over to Google and you can Google search royalty-free images.
All right, there's also another website. It doesn't have too many good ones. If you guys want to write this down, it's called Wikimedia Commons. So kind of like Wikipedia, except take out the P and put in an M.
Like mighty.
Wikimedia Commons.
All right, those are all royalty-free images.
All right, so if I click the upload image option on here, I'm going to choose a file real quick, and there's actually a...
There's someone's business card that's back over here. I'm going to use it again.
Does this show the same on a computer as it would on the mobile device?
Kind of. It'll still change a little bit to fit on your mobile device. Mm-hmm. It'll still have the same content.
So we don't have to worry about sizes and stuff like that.
It'll resize for you. Awesome. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Leaving already?
I'm sorry.
Oh. Oh, that was so sad. Go hug the goat. You know my favorite part about this class is? You started the video after we talked about the goat. I'm not going to know what we're talking about. All right, so is Reed Nord in here? Reed Nord?
No, okay. He's not ours.
Oh, he's not? Okay.
What? That's good.
It's his business. I don't know. It's an image on here, so I'm going to use it.
It's the same one you used earlier. Yeah.
It is. No, he's not in here. No, I'm seeing it. Yeah. It's a good business card.
Yeah. Looks friendly.
Yeah. It's good for Lava Hot Springs. Reed Nord is Lava Hot Springs.
Lava Hot Springs. Yeah.
Next time you see Reed Norn, let him know. Jeff Hunt, Lava Hot Springs. He's not going to know what you're talking about. All right, so once we add that inside.
So, can you do like a PDF document, like you have a chat sheet or something?
Not that I've been able to see. What we've done as a workaround, though. So, since you have the KDIV.com email, and that's linked up in Gmail, you can go to Google Drive, upload your PDF document, okay. And then once you do that, then you can just copy the share link and add it on. It's kind of a workaround. Yeah. If you guys ever go to our website, and you click on some of the stuff, like to download some of the templates we've made, all on Google Drive. Mm-hmm. Now, when I click on that, I'm sorry, I clicked on it really fast. I apologize. When I click on it over here, I click on Mr. Reed Nord. And then there's an option to edit. All right, so if I click on that edit button on here, and then this is where you can actually hyperlink this if you want to as well. All right, so I can change the title, as you were talking about. I was talking about this earlier. I'm so sorry. I've lost all train. Oh, perfect. Okay, there you go. As I said, I've lost all train of thought. I don't think I ever had it, but I've lost it again. All right, so this is where you can put inside the title, whatever you'd like it to populate for. So in this case, maybe if this is what I actually wanted to display on here. All right, you can hyperlink it. Now, anytime you hyperlink anything, if you have this little box over here that you can check, all right, there's an option where it's actually going to take this link to. All right, if it says to open the link in a new tab or new window, click that. All right, because if we don't click it, then once they click on this picture and they go over to whatever our link is, it's going to take them away from our website. We don't want that to happen. All right, so if we click on that to open the link in a new tab, then once they click on it, our website's still going to remain open, so even if they X out of wherever we're taking them to, they still have to go back to our website. Right, we want them to go back to our website. All right, so always check that on here.
They should have it auto-checked.
Right.
And how do you find that screen?
Yeah. So where I got on here, let's say it real quick. Once I add it inside the image.
Once you did what?
Oh, I added in the image. Cool. So click on the image real quick. Try clicking on the image.
Right click.
Weird. No. Left click on it. It went right up. How's yours not doing it? I should say edit. And these are images you just added?
Yeah, I just put them on.
There you go. I guess you have to click right in the middle. And then we'll have the edit option on there.
Okay.
That was weird. Yeah, I'm sorry. That's strange. I haven't seen that. And then once you click on edit, then you can edit it further. Because there's also a chance that this image is going to be over inside Google.
on Google Images. Right, so it's awesome if you're actually over on Google on the first page for, let's say, in this case, LeRoy Marketing East Idaho class. I can only imagine there's nothing on there for that right now. But now if I actually go over to it, this won't happen automatically, right? It's not a, you know, an instant change.
You click on the picture,
and then there's an edit. Yep, click edit right on there.
All right, so we do want to populate over inside the search portion, but we also want to populate, if possible, over inside the images section too. All right, so any new images you might have, fantastic. Now for the position down here, when you are adding an image, I had another Halls. They're not the sugar-free. You guys are freaking me out, FYI. I called my wife and I told her, I was like, I'm screwed. Tomorrow's not going to be good. They told me. She said, every day's a school day. I was like, that's great. I'm not happy though. They're not sugar-free.
Just got down to that last part though, where it's about to fall apart, and I bit into it. Those things taste terrible. All right.
So such a tease.
What do we want the link to say? Just yeah.
The link can be whatever you like. You
so
can
it's
actually,
not necessarily the blog.
You can actually link them back over to your homepage if you want to. You can link them to a different blog post. All right. Maybe you happen to have, say, you're doing a blog on your listing, and you have a picture of it. All right, over inside the link on here, you might want to have the exact link that'll take them to your website where they can view it. Yeah.
I thought they were at my website.
They are.
They are, but they're not looking at that particular listing in this case. You're thinking of that example.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, they're just on the blog page.
Okay.
Or you can hyperlink them back over to the homepage.
So if I put a thing here, when they click on the picture, it'll take them to that other website, but it left mine open. So
bingo.
When they close that, then they come back to where they start.
As long as you leave that.
Okay.
Yeah.
The other thing that we're looking at is you do also have the position. Now if you want to put none on there, it's just going to put it wherever you have it. All right, or you can put it left, center, or right. Now, the reason I might suggest taking a look at this is because if you put it left, for instance, in some cases, you're actually able to go through there and actually write around it. So if you've ever seen those before where they happen to have an image inside a blog, and they have text to the right-hand side, all right, or text to the left-hand side, whatever it may be. All right, I always like to do mine in the center. I'm that guy. All right, if we click on the image too, you can also drag it in, make it smaller. All right, so once I clicked on it again, bottom right, there's a little black square button. And you can make it bigger or smaller. I really hope, like, when people search for Lava Hot Springs, it's TripAdvisor and then this blog. So they'll be so confused.
Would that be so funny?
Yeah, I'm just like, what the? I don't think that's going to happen. But that'd be amazing.
I'd like it to be my blog.
All right, so what are we doing here? We added inside our title. All right, we took that title. We made it our header on here, too. All right, we have our paragraph. This is obviously a sad example of a paragraph.
Yes.
All right, if you're going to add inside additional kind of thoughts on here, so in this case, I'm just talking about, you know, five different places to visit around here. Number one, I put visit Lava Hot Springs. Bold it if you can. Put a number next to it if you'd like to. All right, bolding a number of things are going to help out exponentially. All right, the other big item that we can also add inside is that video. So I'm going to add in a video real quick. All right, so I'm going to click on the insert video option. Is anyone big on YouTube, Vimeo?
Just watching it.
Two people? Watching it? I'll say it anyway. Cat videos are hilarious. Oh my God, so good. There's certain, I'm sure everyone has their own little, I don't subscribe to anyone on YouTube just because I know all the channel names that I want to go to, and there's about three. And then I just kind of search for keywords on there. Cat jump fails, it's one of my favorite things to look at. It's so funny. It's crazy. All right, so once we click on the insert video option, I'm actually going to go to YouTube. All right, I'm going to go to youtube.com/KellerWomans.
Pick one of our
No, what's the, what is it? Oh, actually, you know what? I'll find it. See what pops up. They just uploaded one too. 990 videos.
Yeah, they're busy.
Nice. Oh, you guys, you said you upload all the circle pics stuff? There you go. All right, home for sale. Is there volume on this? Oh, we don't need to hear the volume. I'm glad that you like jumped up though. Like, yeah, there's volume. I love hearing the music in the background. It's like jazzy elevator music every time. I love it so. This is good. It's fantastic. All right, so all you have to do, let's say this is your listing. Is this anyone's listing in here? Oh, does it? Perfect. Cameron Armstrong? Strongarm at KW.com. Yeah, that's good. That was a good one. That's a, good for Cameron. All right. Did you say you hate it? All right, there you go. Oh, they're talking about something else. I was about to say, wow, I'm glad Cameron's not in here. I know. I was about to say, man, poor Cameron.
Sorry, I'm sorry about that.
Oh, no, no problem. I was like, man, I'm so. All right, I was about to say. I was about to say, we're not allowed to bully in this class. Unless they're not here, then you're fine. All right, so what you can do is you can copy this if you want to. You just copy the URL. All right, or there is an option down here. We can click the share button. And I'll actually give you that share code right. Oh, sorry, I clicked the wrong one. The embed code right here. All right, so you have either option. Because if we go back to our blog, it's going to say you can add inside a Vimeo or a YouTube URL, or you can add inside the embed code. All right, so to keep it easy, I know a lot of people. Is anyone on Vimeo? There was like one girl. Oh, that was a video. I was about to say, I was like, that's a cool ringtone. There was one girl that was in this last class that I taught about a month ago that was on Vimeo. Poor girl. Like, nothing on any of the stuff is like, hey, you put in the Vimeo. And we finally got to this, and I was like, Merry Christmas, man. It's here. So YouTube, if you are looking at starting any type of video channel, I would highly suggest YouTube, just because that typically works with just about everything on here. All right, but if I copy that URL and I paste it inside here and I click the insert button, it's right there. So now add it inside. All right, so one thing to note on here, remember, even if you add inside images or videos, all right, you do want to add inside an image if possible. You do want to add inside a video if possible. All right, it's 2016. You were literally writing this blog and the content for the search engines. Everyone else is going to be staring at videos. They'll be staring at images. They'll be on their phone texting. Oh, there's a door there. It's so funny, the broker came by. And he's like, yeah, we're in the class right next door. And I was like, oh, man, I'm so sorry. I'm really loud. He said, oh, no, we can't hear you. And I was like, sure. It's good enough. All right, now, anytime that you ever add inside a blog, one thing that I would highly suggest putting on here. All right, the three things I always suggest putting on. A, see if you can number bullet items, because people are really going to want to look at list. B, add inside a video if possible. C, make sure you have an image in there. All right, at least one, and then you can use that as the featured image, too. I think I said the three things. The four things. Videos, images, and bullets, or numbers if you can. People want to see bullets. Search engines want to see content. People are lazy. All right.
Have you ever downloaded a transcript from a video and get extra content?
I've heard of some people doing that before. The only reason I might suggest not doing it is because it's already somewhere else. So since it's already on YouTube, you'd basically be duplicating it.
Yeah.
So that's the only reason I might not suggest doing it.
Yeah.
What I have seen some people do before, though, speaking of transcripts, if you ever go through and maybe you talk about a home, or maybe you're doing like a walkthrough tour, you have a five-minute video of your new listing, then I've heard people that will actually listen to the video and then transcribe that and put that on there, and since it's technically not written out anywhere else, it's on the video, you can do that too.
So if we're aiming to do that, then we should not put the transcript on YouTube. If we're trying to create the YouTube video for our blog, it's better to have the content in the blog than in YouTube.
I would. The hard part about it, though, is that on YouTube, since it is linked up with Google, that's going to help you out immensely, too. So it's either place you put it is good. That's kind of the end of the, yeah. So it's interesting because Google bought YouTube back in, what, 2012, 2011, 2010, something like that. Mm-hmm. Google and Facebook, if you look at anything else, they own everything. Look at your car. Mine's a Nissan, brought to you by Facebook. So, all right, but the fourth thing I would always highly suggest putting inside here, please, please, please put a call to action. I see so many blogs that are written without a CYA. CTA. Why did I say CYA? Oh, that's not. That's something else. Yeah. Yeah. CTA. Yeah. If you don't know what a CYA is, good for you. CTA is what I've been saying. All right, so you want to put a call to action on here. All right, so at the end. All right, so at the end of this, what we want to put on here is talking about ourselves. All right, if you enjoy this listing, feel free to contact the premier Idaho real estate agent, blank. All right, and then put a link over to your website, put your contact information. All right, create an entire paragraph talking about yourself. All right, it's not cocky, it's good. It's confident. There's a difference between cockiness and confidence. Yes, ma'am.
Is there an optimum size for that video?
You know,
you just use the default size, or
I use the default. It actually just automatically comes in here and does it. If you do want to resize it, I mean, you technically can resize it from here. If not, it'll just automatically give you a default for it.
Okay.
It kind of resizes itself though, so it'll be fine. You are able though. It's a good thing. You can click this little kind of bracket icon, and I'll get you the HTML on here, so you can actually see what the code of your blog will look like. Mm-hmm. And then if you really want to, over here, like I can see the iframe style, youtube.com/embed. It's 500 pixels by 281. So if I wanted to change it, I could change it that way. Or if not, then you can go to YouTube and find the different embeds on there too.
Does it affect the...
How big and small, like if it changes?
On mobile device, what's the word for it?
I don't believe so.
Mobile...
Like responsiveness?
Responsiveness. Yeah. Does it affect that if you change the size?
Yeah, because then on this one, whenever you actually click on it, much like on a YouTube video, it should take up the entire screen.
Can you add audio to any of these?
You can't add audio, unfortunately. Like if you just kind of talk like a podcast type thing, you won't be able to. If there's like an embed option from where you uploaded the audio, you may be able to by placing it right back over here. I haven't seen that quite yet, though. That could work out, yeah. All right, so feel free to go through. I don't know who exactly is writing out their own blog right now.
Or just taking down notes or anything. So I'm trying to get a feel for who was actually writing one of them. Skip over something. Okay.
Are you?
Tell me about it.
I need
some video of this. I don't want all the words. See, look, I'll show you. So I have a whole bunch of videos on the model and stuff. And,
Gotcha. All right, so I'll give you guys a second to go through there and fill the rest of that out.
Number category here, my ordered list.
And if you do want,
number one bold. Yours is bold, Scott. And I'm trying to make my numbered list bold, and
okay.
It's not. It doesn't do that. It gives me a regular one. Here,
mm-hmm.
Just makes me regular. How do I make it?
Go try highlighting it.
Gotcha.
Try this.
But yours is cool. So.
Oh, gotcha. Yeah.
Yeah.
What I did is
I took. Okay, you just did it. So I don't have to use that function.
No.
That's even better.
Yeah. All right. Now, once again, obviously, we can come back and fix this up very soon too. All right. The next thing we're gonna have down here is that excerpt.
All right, now remember, if you leave this blank, you will automatically populate with some of your content that you added on there. And then put those dot, dot, dots. Dad.
That's
definitely
yeah, that is money right
there. I appreciate my husband for starting. Eyes closed, face up. All right, so if you want to add inside your excerpt on here, it's typically a shortened version of the post and will appear anytime a visitor
is previewing the post before clicking through. All right, so this is the reason as to why they should click on that. All right, so in this case, maybe I just want to type out maybe one or two sentences.
You just copy. That's a terrible one. But regardless, there's one on there.
All right, if you want to, you can just copy the first couple sentences if you don't want to have those dot, dot, dots.
So what is this excerpt?
So if anyone ever kind of hovers over us,
yes, if you go back on this homepage, for instance, it's this portion that'll display right here,
okay.
Right at the bottom. So they didn't put one in, so it automatically just takes the beginning information and then just put the dot, dot, dot where they run out. Yeah.
So, if you want to put a code in, why do you do that?
You can add inside code. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. But if you click the bracket, is it brackets? Is that what I should be saying?
I don't know.
The less than greater than sign. There you go. Is that comfortable?
Okay, so I've got this code right here. I'll just try it and see what happens.
See if it pops up. I've seen it pop up a couple times. I haven't seen it on other occasions.
It doesn't want to have to fire replacement. When you're entering, do you want a regular font or do you want bold or anything?
So it'll be a regular font because you actually can't change it.
Oh, you can't change
it. Yeah. No, so on here you can't change anything on it. But you do want to add inside. If possible, I would suggest just adding the first or second sentence.
First two sentences. Can we go
back? That works. Dude, I don't know. Stop looking at me.
You're right. Whatever.
Whatever, man. All right. We got two more hours. Okay. All right, and you also want to do that featured image. Now, if you have multiple images on your page,
select the one that you think will bring people over, the one that best talks about what your blog and piece will be about.
All right, so add inside whatever image you want to, Mr. Reed Nord, Mr. Hot Lava Springs. Sounds like a model contest that you won. Is there a Miss Hot Lava Springs? Please tell me there is.
Probably not.
Probably not, okay.
It's probably small enough. There's
there might be, because they do that festival.
When is it? Is it tomorrow?
No.
Oh, man, I was about to say, so I'm entering myself as a Miss Hot Lava Springs. All right, now I'm going to throw the meta title and meta description on here. The entire back row is gone. Like flies. Oh, no. They'll be gone. Usually it's always the people in the back who leave first. All right, so on the meta title, meta description, this is where you can add inside whatever you'd like to. All right, so once again, I'm going to go and add inside my title. This might be over 55 characters. I haven't counted it out. All right, then for the meta description, 155 characters or less on what you want to add. Sorry, display on here in the search results.
Can I ask a question about images? Mm-hmm. I'm sorry, if the image has a watermark, it's probably not going to be free and all of that.
There is a good chance that might happen. Oh,
well,
it might be on here if it's, I haven't been to this site before, what says pricing of plans? Is that on the page?
I'm thinking you might have to pay for it first, and then the watermark will come on. Royalty-free images might not be royalty. It's royalty-free after you pay for it, and then it's just, you can own it. It's yours.
That's what I'm learning. Thank you.
Of course. All right, so for the meta description, I'm going to type something in real quick. I know. I'm just capitalizing every other letter.
It doesn't appear that there is a list
of oh, thank you.
Well, I asked my boss because she's from there. And she didn't know, so I Googled it. And I don't see anything.
Oh, very cool. Using company time well today, I see.
Yes, unfortunately, she's used to that. Unfortunately, you won't be able to enter yourself into that contact.
Then I will have to make it tomorrow.
Another place you should go is Mesa Falls, which is closer to here, I believe.
All right. Mason Falls?
Mesa Falls.
Oh, Mesa Falls? Cool. Waterfalls?
Yeah.
Go there. All right, so I'm going to click the save option at the bottom down here. Yeah, I'm used to it, man.
Yeah.
It's not humid out here. I'm not sweating standing outside, so that's nice.
But Craters of the Moon tends to, like, the ground is kind of black and it's hot and then heat radiates off of it.
I'm used to that.
It does feel like you're on the moon.
That's awesome. Hot. It's like stepping outside.
You're training the astronauts, right? You use the train. Mm-hmm.
All right, so once we click that save option, we scroll back down here, then we're going to see all of our posts. All right, here's that new one, the one that I made, LeRoy Marketing East Idaho class. There's the name, that'll be the slug URL. All right, so now if you ever hear someone talk about a slug URL, you know it's the portion that comes after your domain. All right, so in this case, scottleroy.com/, it might be blog/, and then this. We'll find out. All right, but now I'm going to go back to my homepage and refresh this. And there's Mr. Norton. That's automatically pop up. So now we happen to have, here's our featured image. Here's the title we put inside there. And here's our excerpt. And then they can read more by clicking on it. And if you click on read more, I'll take them right back over here to where the featured image shows up again. So watch out for that. Take them right back over to the post that you can take a look at. All right, there'll be an option over here where they can actually share it online. They can contact you directly too.
Are you able to? Oh, you are able to.
If I save that. This and want to change it, you can.
Oh, yeah. You can change anything. Yeah. No. Oh, I'll tell you like 80 times if there's anything you can't change. Yeah. Now, on here, you can also go to your blog page too. So mine's under About. But if I go to my blog page on here, then it'll actually show all the different blogs that they can click onto. It's on your blog page. You'll literally have, well, all of your blogs. Kind of makes sense. I know. Now, once you have that completed, I'm going to click back over on Mr. Lava Hot Springs. All right, once we're on that page, obviously I probably don't want to use this image because it's stretching it out really far. All right, once we're on that page, then I can copy, and I know you guys can't see it over here too well, but at the very top, I can copy that URL. All right, there's a couple places I might suggest putting it. I would put it over on any social media channel that you have, right? Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, Instagram, if you want to type everything out. Oh, you don't have to type everything out. You can copy and paste it over. All right, Google+, LinkedIn. You guys are utilizing Hootsuite. You can just post it all out everywhere.
Sweetthing.com.
No, it's yeah.
Don't do that.
Sweet thing. So it's Hootsuite. Hootsuite is a platform you can utilize for your social media. Their pro account is $10 a month. Their free account though is free. You get up to, I know, how about that? You get up to three different I don't want to talk to you. All right, so on here, if you have the pro account, you get up to 50 different social media channels that you can actually utilize. All right, so you can post out your same message to all different social media channels at once. This is what we actually use over here so we can help manage different social media platforms. If you want to use the free one, say you happen to have LinkedIn, Facebook, and Twitter. All right, then use the free one on here because you get up to three different profiles for free. So whenever you happen to create a blog, you don't want to go through Facebook, LinkedIn, and Twitter and paste it all out. All right, then you just add it right over here and send it out for once, and you're done.
How much was it for?
$10. Yeah, or they had a deal. I did this where you can buy it for a year and you save like 10%, 20%.
And what three social media sites do you think are the most powerful in real estate?
Facebook?
YouTube? Put me on the spot on that one. I get this question all the time, but it's hard to think about it.
Because those are the two that I like to utilize. Definitely Facebook because everyone with their dog is there. Definitely YouTube because YouTube is owned by Google. And then if you're looking for referrals, LinkedIn. The only issue I have with Twitter is that you have to tweet a lot. You can get lost in that pretty fast. Google Plus, not as many people utilize it, but because it's owned by Google, that's another one to use too. Pinterest is fantastic as well, just because that way you can actually backlink over to your site. So say you happen to have a new listing and you go on Pinterest and you create like a you go on Pinterest all the time or something? Okay, cool. I don't know.
Sometimes.
You just like perked up and smiled. And I was like, yeah, it's cool. We're talking about crafts. All right. So on Pinterest, you can make like a pin board and you can make it just about your listing. And then you can put all the different pictures of your listing on there and then link it back over to your website too. So that way it would help out with SEO because you're getting backlinks. But then at the same time, it's also coming through a well-known social media site. I would say bare minimum Facebook and YouTube if possible. Smartphones are very nifty. All right. If you don't happen to have a cinematography degree, you don't have a camera crew that follows you around all day, don't worry about it. Take your smartphone. I see a lot of people have iPhones. Some people have droids. All right, so take it. Although droids do take better pictures. And I'm an iPhone user. I will say that. Go around. Take a video. Walk around the neighborhood. All right, whatever it may be. Put it online. People don't want to see someone that had an entire cinema crew come through and update it. They're okay with seeing amateur stuff. Trust me. I've got followers. I have amateur stuff.
Have you ever used it, this than that?
Oh, yeah. I did, and then I stopped using it just because I liked going back to Hootsuite for everything. But that is another one that you can check out, too.
Do you do they say you should do on Facebook, have a business page, on your personal page, do 90% personal and 10% business. Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Stage?
Yeah.
Is that what you?
That's what I would suggest. Yeah. Business? Yeah. So on Facebook, you have a business page, and then you also have a personal profile. So if I go to, check this out real quick. Oh, that's not what I want to go to. All right. So if I go to facebook.com/ScottLeRoyMarketing, and this is my business page. Oh, there's no X button on here. That's fine. All right, it's on my business page. Then we're going to have our timeline. We have likes on here of who's actually liked it. Can't believe we have that many likes. That's interesting. I don't pay attention to that very often. But then this is where you can actually set this up. Let me see. If I get a bunch of friend requests today, I'm going to know who did it. I think it's this. Yeah, all right, never mind. I'll try one more. So I can show you the difference between them two. No, that's not what I wanted. I'm sorry. There you go. That is not me, but that works. All right, so this is a Facebook profile for someone in Connecticut, and I think his daughter. Yeah.
On your Facebook profile, you don't have ad as brand new stuff.
Oh, I do? I've got some security settings on there.
Maybe that I know that.
I don't even know it, so don't even worry about it. It's probably my security settings on there. Is this? No, I have no clue. I don't know where it's. Oh, thanks. Did you find me?
Yeah.
Oh, obviously. I can't even find myself. That's me.
Yeah.
Yeah. Thank you. She was going to come over here today, but then she had work. It's weird. It's Friday. We went to the mall yesterday, like 2, because we got in at a weird time. I felt weird walking around at like 2 on a Thursday at a mall. There was no one there, and I felt out of place. I was like, I shouldn't be here. This is not where I need to be right now. So it was interesting. All right, but obviously post that out on any different sites. Hootsuite's another one to jot down. I always like to give you guys as much advice on what you can get for free. So once again, if you don't have a second cell phone number, Google Voice, jot that one down too. Google Voice, that's free. I'd highly suggest getting that. Before I had my other phone line, we were using Google Voice. So I technically have two phone numbers. Even if you have no intention of utilizing, just get one. Just a habit, why not? If you guys ever need logos created, I probably shouldn't say this, but you guys might actually know about this website, Fiverr. Fiverr.com. Fiverr.com. You can get anything for about $5.50 now. That's why I got the Scott LeRoy marketing logo. It was created back in 2012 for $5 before they increased it by $50.
You know, if the Google Voice number, if I forward, because I've multiple email accounts,
yeah,
but I can't forward multiple Google numbers to the same device, right?
Correct. You can only do one per, yeah.
So I need to carry a bag with six phones.
Yeah, you'll need a big cell phone carrier. Anything for $5, pretty much.
Logos.
I mean, whatever your heart desires, yeah.
Okay.
So, but usually graphic design, yeah. Correct. So yeah, and literally, it was come out here, Fiverr.com. I will design a stunning logo, literally right away.
Yeah.
Perform your drum parts. Record a professional voiceover. I had someone at my class last week say, "I got my logo from here," and they bought 8 logos. I wouldn't suggest doing that. All right, just spend $5, get a logo if you want to. And then they also did an additional item where they had a jingle made, and they played it for me, and I was like, that's cool.
Different.
Yeah, it was definitely different. I was like, that's interesting. All right, so I always like to go over that too, because everyone always asks, where can I get a logo made? And obviously there are other people that are, you know, they're preferred vendors at KW and whatnot, but I know that some of you guys might not want to pay, you know, that price. Yeah. So I try to help you guys out as much as possible. Hopefully I do an okay job. And if you need a domain, GoDaddy, 99 cents on Google. I'll get you for $1.17 for the first year. All right. Now we've kind of gone over the blog section. I know they wanted me to talk about blogs for 3 hours, and I was like, I kind of want to go over some additional stuff too on the side. That's okay.
Can you spell check on your blog?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, yeah. It did it for me. It kind of gives you a little squiggly on the bottom.
Oh, it does? It tells you when you're
a little red squeaky.
Yeah, it told me. All right. Now we're back over here. Right next to blog posts, there's also the option for pages. We didn't get to go over this in the first class because, well, the first class was how to set up your website in 5 minutes. And it took 3 hours. Because we did the advanced setup. When you have a trainer, they get sidetracked every 3 seconds. It's understandable.
You lost the shiny objects.
There are plenty of shiny objects. I had to close down the window purely for that. I don't know what's coming down there.
Oh my gosh.
You know what though? I've never been told at the end of a class that it felt like 6 hours.
Nope.
They usually say it felt like 5. We knocked off an hour, man. All right, so I'm going to click the pages option on here. All right, and this is how you can actually add new pages. All right, so he's not in here anymore. There was someone that was actually here on the city document section over there. He had a different website, and before he left, he told me he wasn't going to be here, so this is perfect. He said, I've got another website. I've got some pages that I did, and I want to move them over here. How can I go about doing that? I said, easy. Create a new page, copy and paste it over, delete the old page. All right, so if you have a website right now, maybe you have the eEdge or the eAgency website, and you want to just kind of move some of that content over that you created, maybe you did some blog posts on your eAgency side, if you guys have like the piggyback blog stuff, copy it, move it over, delete it. All right, so copy it, move it over to the new site, delete it from the old site. I should probably say that instead of just copy, move, delete. All right, but if we click the plus sign on here, obviously you can edit or remove any pages that you see on here. All right, but if we click the plus sign on here, it's going to allow us to create a brand new page. All right, so if I click on the plus sign, now you guys have already seen the blog back end. All right, this is going to be very, very similar. All right, so as you can see, we automatically, yeah, it's similar in theory.
Okay.
Yeah. All right, so on here, as you can see, you're going to have page style, page content, and there's going to be an option on here that this mouse keeps like falling down, so sorry about that. There is an option on here that will automatically be selected that says add this page to my menu. All right, so if you want this to automatically be added to your menu, please click on that, and I would highly suggest it, right, so that you can find it. That menu is kind of how you're going to be able to find everything. Play around with it. That's cool, isn't it?
Not a Facebook page, right? She can't just put a Facebook page, right?
Like just move that as a page?
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. No.
That's correct. That's right. You cannot do that.
I told her no, and I was like, let me check.
It's like an elongated no. It's like how a goat would say no. I feel like a peasant up here. I've got like half-eaten food. I've got a broken cookie. I'm just like, let's just eat it. Just keep going. All right, so on here, you do have a couple different default pages you can go from. There's an about page that's on here, an agent's index page. If you guys are on a team, any teams in here?
Yeah.
Cool. Two. Awesome. All right, well, there is an agent's page on here. Everyone always asks, you know, if we have these websites, they're always given to each agent individually. How do we make it a team one? Well, I always kind of tell them one thing. Use one website, all right, whatever it may be. If you have five people on your team, you're going to have five different websites. Make one the default and use that one. But there is an option on here where you can actually display agent information too. That's, I just want to show that on there. You have the areas index, blog posts like we were talking about before, clients, contact page, listing search. If you ever add any testimonials inside, all right, you do have to manually add the testimonials over, which is good and bad. It's good because you know it's going to get put on there and obviously it'll get done. I can only imagine that when you guys close on any type of deal, whether it's buyer or seller, you probably ask for a testimonial on different websites, and 89% of the time they might not deliver on them. So in this case, if you say, hey, email it over to me, there's a much higher possibility they're actually going to do it than say, hey, please go to Zillow, fill out this form on here. You might have to click this. All right. And then featured listings as well. All right, so I'm going to use default page template. All right, that's kind of the stock one on here. All right, so I'm literally just going to call this test real quick. All right, once I do that, it did go away. So I'm going to click on that little checkbox that says add this page to my menu. All right, and then for page content, you can literally go through and add just about anything that we added previously. All right, so you have your formatting options. You have bold, italicized, underlined, bullet, number. We didn't talk about hyperlinking before. I apologize. Because one thing I would suggest on blogs, if you are going to utilize your keyword, try hyperlinking that keyword and then see if you can actually hyperlink it back to maybe a different blog or even a different page about that keyword. All right, so if I type in Scott LeRoy Marketing on here, why do I keep doing that? I can't even type my own name. All right, but if I highlight all of this, and then I click on the link option, I apologize, we didn't go over this previously. All right, then you can actually insert a link on here. No, that's cool.
This is badass. Everything is terrible.
I'm sure Bill's supposed
to
do it.
Sit there in front of Bill. Why not? Yeah. All right, so if I insert a link on here, then it's going to ask me for the URL. Here's that button. Pop quiz. Do we want to check it?
Yes.
Man, that first class is like, yes! And then now it's like, eh. You do it, man. It works. I love second classes. They're always my favorite. But yeah, I can't even spell this correctly either.
Yeah.
I shouldn't even be in business. I'm just here. All right, so I'm going to click insert on here. All right, so now if I ever post this and I'm going to click on it, it'll take us over. We'll take a look at that in a second. Now, this might actually benefit everybody, so that's good. Thank you for speaking up. Good for you. All right. What's the guy's name? The hot spring guy?
Love.
Yeah. Oh. Well, yeah. What's his name?
Carter, you've been using.
Yeah.
Name?
Reed. Reed. Perf. Awesome. Perf. Perfect. All right. So you wanted to know how to add it over Google Drive. This will probably benefit everyone, too.
Like, we have monthly statistics. I want to be able to save that.
Cool. All right. So if you want to add in hyperlinks from Google Drive, why not? This would be perfect for blog posts and for pages as well. All right, so since you have a kw.com email, you are linked up with Google Drive. Training room folder. There's literally one on here already for Reed Nord. He's all over the place. All right, so if you want to, all you have to do, you can just click the new option at the top left up here once you log into Google Drive. All right, so drive.google.com.
So
if I'm on my Google page, is
there a way to just get to my Google friend? I don't know. It's Google page. Yeah.
Right up here, drive.google.com. So just right there, just do the drive. Okay. Do the drive.
That's what I thought. That's what I thought there was a way to.
You guys are making some pretty sweet catchphrases today, FYI. What's the word? All right, so once I click on the, is that to me or is that, oh, it's your computer, okay. So once I click on the new option at the top left, I'm going to click the file upload button so I can actually upload a file on here. So if you guys are ever wondering how you download those calendars, I don't know if you guys download the calendars that are on our website or anything. This is what we do as well. So we just kind of add it over here and then we hyperlink it on a page. Well, if I go to file upload, and I'm going to come through here, that's all on the desktop. So I'm going to go over to downloads real quick. Oh, there's a lot more on here now.
Like stuff in here.
That's fine. We'll use this bold step. Here we go. All right. So I'm going to select this, the bold two-step PowerPoint. Perfect. So it should upload for me. There we go. All right. So once you add that inside, so you click new and then you do the file upload. It looks like it's uploading right now. All right. Right over here, I'm going to select this. So I'm going to click to the right of it. I'm going to right-click on it. I'll do a shareable link. Why not?
I'm going to go to, so right click on it, and we're going to go to get shareable link.
You right click on it?
Mm-hmm. I like this. Now, when I click on get shareable link,
right over here, it's going to say link sharing on. Anyone with the link can view. I want to make sure that's correct. Because sometimes it'll actually go through and it'll say only people that are in your group can view this, or sorry, that are logged in. I don't want that to happen because I want anyone to be able to view this, so, right, as long as they have the link.
So mine says just anyone at Cal Rollins Realty can view.
Right. Yeah. So if it shows it on there, then click on sharing settings.
Okay. Because I want it to be everyone.
Mm-hmm. Because once you, exactly, you want it to be everybody on here.
Gotcha.
Because once you click on sharing settings, yep, then you'll look for anyone with the link can view. All right, you want to make sure that's view, not edit or comment or anything. You want to make sure it's view. And I'll click OK. All right, and then you can just copy this. Nope, not all of that.
I don't want them to edit.
That's correct.
Yep, only view on there.
Then you can copy that link, and that's what you can add in as your text on your page.
This one. This one I can leave blank.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can leave that blank. Okay. So the reason she was asking about this is I guess you guys get some market statistics that come out, and she's looking to add them over as, I guess they're PDFs. So if you want to add like a PDF on your page or on a blog or anything, this is a great way where you can host it online and then add it over directly too. So if you guys are wondering why are we on Google Drive or anything of that sort. Gotcha. So once you copy this, yeah. So then I'll go back. So on this page, I can add inside whatever I want to. So maybe I just want to type in bold presentation. Yeah. Dude, I hate new keyboards. And then you can hyperlink it like we did before when I did the Scott LeRoy marketing one and then paste it right inside. So whenever someone clicks on this, and we'll do it in a second to see what it looks like, it'll take them over to view it too.
Is there a trick? Like, I can't
Yes.
Yeah, so a good shortcut if you're on a PC, Control C will copy, Control V will paste, and if you're on a Mac, it's Command C and Command V for copy and paste. All right, I'm going to open the link in a new tab on here. And then once again, we can add inside our meta title and our meta description if we'd like to.
Why is it V instead of P for paste?
Yeah.
P is for print.
P is for print, yeah.
Okay.
It's American, that's right. Yeah, that's the correct answer. Deal with it. All right, so I'm just going to go ahead and save this. I'm going to skip over the SEO, meta title, meta description. All right, but once you save this, it's going to save, and then it should automatically pop up like it does right here. This page was added to your menu. All right, this page was added to the last item in your menu. Would you like to edit the menu label or order? All right, so then you can either click close if you're okay with that or edit menu. All right, because once I click on edit menu, it's going to display all of our menu items on here, and the last one down.
Yeah.
Is going to be our title, and then we can actually go through, we can edit the label on here, we can move it up or down, we can put it as a subpage. All right, whatever you want to do, you're able to add on here. All right, so I'm going to leave it as is and actually just check on my website real quick. All right, so here's that new page that we just added over. When we add it inside that page, once I click on it, there you go. All right, so this is all that I have on the page. I just had two links. All right, so if I click on Scott LeRoy Marketing, it's going to take me over to the scottleroymarketing.com website. That's a new tab on here. And if I click on Bold Presentation, that's going to take me over to our Google Drive where we can download that. Because now they're going to have the option to open this with whatever they choose, or whatever's available. And they also have on here the download option too. All right, so I'd highly suggest utilizing your Google Apps as well. Since you're with KW, you get the kw.com email that's linked up with Gmail and Google Apps. I don't know if you guys know this or not, but how many gigabytes do you guys get storage-wise with that? You guys know?
30.
30, that's correct.
Pretty good.
I know. All right, with the normal Gmail account, you typically get 15, but with the KW.com one, since it's a Google Apps one, all right, so that's why it ends with KW.com, you get double the amount, so you get 30. All right, so you get even more storage on your email, on Google Drive, Google Docs, Google Sheets. All right, so even if you have no intention of utilizing your KW.com email, use it purely for all the storage capabilities like this. All right, it'll help you out. I don't use my KW.com email. I have it forwarded over to my scottleroymarketing.com email. All right, but in this case, I do store a good amount of stuff on here. All right, so then if I never need to access anything or I need to download anything later on, I have it available 24/7. Does anyone use Google Drive or Google Apps? Go, people. Yep. It's the new flash drive. It's cloud computing, so you can access it anywhere in the world.
We always use Dropbox. Mm-hmm. We're starting to. So can Google Drive really replace Dropbox?
Yeah, they're pretty much the same thing. Yeah. In fact, you'll probably get more storage with Google Drive. Just because on Dropbox, you start with 2 gigabytes of storage, which back when it came out was like a lot. And then Gmail, just a basic Gmail account that you can set up in 5 seconds for free, you get 15. So we're already giving you 7.5 more. 7.5? 7.5 times, I guess. Yeah. If we're adding, yes, that's correct. All right. Now, once again, if you ever want to change this order, remember you can go under the site option. All right. We went under sites. And under site setting, remember you can find your menu option on there if you ever want to change that order of the menu on here. So I keep forgetting to ask this. Does anyone have any questions? I'm so sorry.
We just ask them.
I was about to say, you guys have been pretty good about asking stuff. So that's nice.
On the pages, can you have a slideshow for
or even in posts, blog posts, can you have a slideshow picture?
If you can have a slideshow, if it's able to be added in over to that HTML section, you can, but you won't be able to just add in like a slideshow.
Okay.
Yeah. Yes, ma'am.
I have your favorite listings on my mail now. What is that?
That actually comes from when people are on your site and they sign in. That's where they will actually see all their favorite listings. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I just learned about that the other day, too.
Do people use it?
It's a brand new site, so I have no clue. I would think so, though. It's very similar to your eEdge site where they can go inside and they can kind of favorite them and come back to them at any time. I use the – true story. I actually use the KW app to find my home, and I used a KW agent. I feel like I can tell you guys that here because I used to – right after I bought the home, like a week later, I taught a class like maybe 10 minutes from my home, and I said, oh, it's great. I just bought a home. And they all looked at me like, why didn't you use me? And I was like, I didn't know you guys existed. So there you go. But on here, I use the KW app because then it can search around GPS location, obviously. But in this case, I was able to find favorite stuff. So it's the same thing on here. So as long as you're able to find favorite and come back, it helps out a lot. Because I know a lot of them are usually looking, they're like, well, keep them back in my mind, see if the price changes. That's what I did. And then I bought it. All right, there is one other big area that I do want to talk about on here, and that's the testimonial section. Because I'm sure you guys know this as real estate agents. All right, referrals are a huge source of your business. Big, big source. You missed the login section. We're like doing a mix of it every time. Okay. My mom's a teacher. She used to have observations all the time. She's like, yeah, they gave me the same thing. They didn't pay attention. They just wrote five. I was like, cool. Is five good? She's like, yep. So right when he said that, I was like, getting graded. All right. So if we click on the testimonial section, you do want to add those inside. What I would highly suggest if you guys aren't doing this right now, whenever you're at a closing, all right, take a picture with them. Take a picture in front of their home. Ask them, can I use this on my website? All right. Get a testimonial from them as soon as possible. Right after they close. Send them an email. Ask them to send over a testimonial. That's when they're the happiest. All right. A day before, if he had asked me for a testimonial, I would have said no, because Bank of America called me 80 times within 3 days about the mortgage. But then I signed those documents, and I got a home and a rake.
And a rake? Because he has a lot of leaves.
There are so many leaves of this home, man. I'll bring it up. It was built in 1953. There's a hoarder that lived in it for 14 years and a rental. Oh, no, it's cool in my case because they had to remodel everything. So I know, right? Yeah. So that it looks great now, but there's so many leaves. All right. That's about all I can say. So let's click the plus sign under testimonials to add one in, and then we will need to add a testimonials page.
I thought we already had it.
I'm just curious, so like on the previous Keller Williams website that they have, like there's lots of different options on here, like find an agent, find an office, you know what I mean? Like there's a whole bunch of different links, and obviously you still have your menu buttons and stuff like that.
You're talking about this website?
The old one, the old Ian.
Yeah, like so if you were just to like, search anybody's name in here, and Keller Williams, mm-hmm. Idaho Falls, and then like, and it'll bring it up. And so it shows your picture, all this stuff, and there's different places you can go. But that is all stuff that was obviously like, I don't know, like it's kind of like that one.
Yeah. So you're on here. So you're going over like the profile type area.
Yeah. Well, yeah. But I mean, the one that you're showing everybody how to put together and build right now. Mm-hmm. Like, I mean, it's literally you would have to go in and put every single one of those things in there is what you're saying, right? I mean, like, it doesn't come and nothing's pre-really set up for you at all. Like,
no, some of the stuff's pre-set up, but you do want to customize it too. Right. Yeah, because like when you first bring it out of the box and you just click like launch live, it won't have your name or your email or phone number or your pictures or anything of that sort. And it'll just be kind of the basic generic one. So you will have to kind of set it up a little bit, similar to those other sites that were set up. You don't have to set up too much on there. What are you talking about, like on this over here, where you can search for an agent? Because that is a good thing. I do need to go over, if you guys are looking at utilizing this new site, if they do search for you on KW.com, because there is a chance they'll do it on here, there is a visit my website link. So for Joshua Adams, for instance, if I click on visit my website, it's going to his e-agency site. All right, so in this case, I'll show you guys where you can actually change that to. But is this the type of site you're talking about, like just kw.com to search on?
Oh, cool, your profile. Yeah.
Like, so if I search somebody's name or whatever and I have balls, you know, like it'll bring stuff up. And at the very top, like it says, like in Spanish, find an agent, find an office, you know, like all those little tiny things
yeah.
up there. So on this new one, if you're doing like you view it, those aren't there.
Correct. Yeah.
So do we have to add?
So you wouldn't be able to add these links like right up here or anything, because this is actually for kw.com, because the page you're looking at is just your profile under kw.com, like this agent's right here.
Okay.
So that would be linked up with this site.
I understand.
Yeah. So okay. That's, yeah. So this one would be like a completely different one. But you did bring up a good point that I need to go over too.
Okay.
So thank you. All right. But I'm going to click that plus sign for testimonials. And someone said, don't we already have a testimonials page? I believe you do.
Is that on the blog that we had that block for testimonials?
I believe
that.
It was a page.
Yeah.
It was a page.
Oh, under the page option, yeah. There is an option for like template testimonials,
but I don't think one's created white.
Okay.
I may confuse you, I'm sorry.
Okay, nope. That's easy to do.
All right, so once I click that plus sign on here. All right, so for a testimonial, if you want to add one inside, so I'm going to add in. Click, please. There we go. Great. All right. Greatest ever, there you go.
All right, so for your title, you can make it whatever you want to. I've seen some people do titles as just the name. I've seen them do it as the property address. I've seen them type inside, you know, a legitimate title. All right, it's completely up to you. There's no right or wrong answer. The wrong answer is not getting a testimony. The right answer is getting one. Don't move for me.
Make me fit. All right. Now, obviously, under testimonial, I'm pretty sure you guys can figure this one out. All right, this is where you'll want to put inside that testimonial.
I used to teach drumline back in the day. I probably shouldn't have done this. It was a high school, and I used to grade them on a scale of subpar to mediocre. I'd give them all twos. And there was no, like, level. It was just a two. It could have been out of one. I don't know.
They won that year. I'm telling you. My methods are not traditional, but they work, I guess. All right, now for referrer on here, this is where you can actually put inside who the referral's from. All right. So if this came from John Smith. Put inside John Smith. And their affiliation on here can be whatever you'd like it to be. More than likely, probably client, buyer, seller.
It's a good view.
You were in the 90s.
We're at
You're like right around the 2 level. All right. So for affiliation, we put on here client. All right, should this testimony be featured?
To tell you the truth, I don't know what this does, so check it.
I can only imagine this would actually feature it over on the homepage, because if you look on my homepage, since I had a testimonial, if I go back to the homepage real quick, your testimonials will display on your homepage as well. Here's another one from John Smith. Scott helped us out, and that's it. All right, so I'm just going to click on the featured option. All right, once again for the excerpt, I've seen some testimonials coming from some clients of ours, and there are people that write novels.
They will write all about everything that they love. It's crazy. I think the stat is, and I'm sure it's from 2012, is that for every one person that writes something positive online, there are 10 people that will write something negative. Yeah.
Sure, it's like 50.
Yeah, sure. That's from 2012. That's right. Multiply that. All right, so if you happen to have an excerpt and it's a longer one, obviously just take, you know, a couple of the sentences, add it inside. I'm just going to copy this as is. All right, now the featured image on here.
If possible, go and put inside, obviously, a landscape image. All right, maybe of the home that they purchased, maybe of them in front of the home, maybe of just them in general signing the documents of the title company.
A selfie, whatever you want to put inside here. I would highly suggest putting inside a picture of whatever it might be from the testimonial, typically the buyer or seller. All right, obviously make sure that they're okay with you utilizing this. All right, because then once you create this testimonial, where should you place it? Should you just leave it on your website?
That's right, Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. Make a blog out of it if you want to.
All right, it's up to you. All right, so I'm gonna use that choose file over here. It's a poor guy. Feels so bad. All right, and same thing for meta title and meta description too. All right, that's where you can actually add inside.
I may suggest copying over that title again. And then for the meta description, up to 155 characters, we just talk about the experience that they had.
All right, so I could go inside here. I just want to put John Smith testimonial.
Do you give any feedback to place your own?
I do not. What's wrong?
It'd be nice to have a character counter.
Yeah. Agree. Yeah. There is a group that's about 6,000 KW agents, and they have a giant Facebook like post of what they want. And Seth Price is one of the main placer people. He's kind of one of the main marketers over there. So he's part of the group, and a couple other placer people are as well. And they kind of have it pinned to the top of what they want. And these are kind of just everything that we would probably suggest. And I can only imagine there's about 150, 160 in there. I'll double check. I'm not going to read through 150 of them. But if there's not, I'll add it over there for character count.
And a word count.
Yeah.
Body.
I agree. Yeah, because I know, because this is based off the WordPress platform, if anyone's ever utilized WordPress before. Yeah. And WordPress does have a word counter whenever you're creating any type of page or any type of blog.
And a character counter.
It does, yeah. Because it's built in with, you guys might not know what this is, it's built in with Yoast. And that's kind of an SEO tool where you can actually see they have like green, yellow, red. Green is where you want to be. Yellow is you're okay. Red, you don't want to be in that level as far as how your page or post is for SEO. In this case over here, they don't have it back here. I wish they did because it's easy just to be like, oh, I'm in the green. I'm good to go. Right, or I'm in the yellow. I need to tweak a couple things. All right, but once we add over those testimonials, all right, then we do want to go back over to our pages section. Right, so I'm going to go to pages, and I have a testimonials one on here, so I'm going to remove this real quick. All right, and when you're under your pages section, just click on the plus sign. Four pages on here. All right, as you see, default, we're going to go to testimonials index. Right, and for the page title, I'd highly suggest titling it testimonials. And then add this page to my menu, you'll be good to go.
All right, so once you add over that testimonials index, then all of your different testimonials that you add back here will automatically populate over for you.
What's a good number of testimonials for a web page?
Ooh, that's a good question. However many positive testimonials you can get. I'd say 10 is probably the bare minimum I would have on there. Since this one's just listed out, 10 would be a good one, 10 or up. I'd say maybe cap at like 20. Because no one's really going to be reading all of them. They might read through a couple of the first ones. If you have like 40, 50, 60 on there, I don't think they'll read all of them. So I would definitely just 10 is a good one. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yes, ma'am.
Can you show us again, if you did this morning, how to add a sub-page?
Yeah, of course. Sorry, my throat's getting all scratchy. My eyes are watering over here.
Yeah. Such a knees.
I know. That goat, man, I'm allergic.
I know, goat. How close did you get to the goat?
They told me, they're like, hold it like a dog. And I said, I've got two cats. What does that mean? And they said, you hold it like this. And they just, like, she held it, and I was like, cool, put it back on the ground, I'll pick it up. And she said, no, here you go. And I was like, oh, all right. And then you just hold it under, like, I don't know, like you have someone in a headlock. It was interesting. It's just like the worst headlock of all time. But there you go. It was great for a goat. Okay, so to move the pages around, you put your cursor on here. It's right where it says listing search, for instance. And once you get those four arrows, hold down with your left mouse. You can move it around wherever you want to. That's if I want to put it below Scott LeRoy Marketing, then I'll find the open space comes up. Now, for instance, if I want to put it as a subpage, I would hold down on that and I put it on top of Scott LeRoy Marketing.
Scott, how did you get to this? I've been trying to get to there all night.
Yeah, of course.
This what?
No, go ahead. No, please, please, please. This will show if I'm doing good.
We went to our first, the KW site, and then went to the over there, view details.
That was a subtle
hint. Sorry, yeah, it wasn't subtle hint, but I was,
it was good.
So where do we go from view details?
Yeah, come right down under listing.
Close.
And then you keep going to the same one.
Yep, there you go. Good job.
So if you wanted to do, I want to do statistics from our MLS.
Mm-hmm.
I want to do subpages for each area.
Okay.
So you just create real estate trends and then do a page, Ketchum trends, Sun Valley trends, Haley trends, and then move those up as subpages.
Pages. Exactly. Yeah.
Okay.
So they'll all still be pages at the end of the day.
Okay.
These will just be subpages of them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
Ah, there you go. So what do y'all think of the new site so far? Do you like it? Easier to use? Yeah. Have you guys checked it out on your phones? Tablets yet?
Not yet.
Yeah. That's right, because that'll help you with how you're actually found on there. Now you want it, yeah.
What about putting a website, who you like to have down, like your dream or why you got into real estate?
Yeah.
The history.
Yeah, of course. So if you guys are looking at actually updating the about page, that's why I probably highly suggest that. There is the pages option on here, and it will give you a kind of a generic about. So if you click on pages, then you can go under about and actually edit this. You won't be able to add it over to your home page, unfortunately, just because that kind of just is set in stone with what auto-populates on there. But under here, you can update your about. And I actually think this is the generic text. It's good. I mean, don't get me wrong. It's nice. But I think that is the generic text that pops up for you. Now, you brought something up earlier. I'm going to touch base on this now. Look at this. We're going off-roading again. I swear it's a four-wheeler day. We got goats. We got wheels. We have two screens. It's great. Exactly. I'm like Taco Bell. I'm not really sure what that means, but we're calling it as is. All right. So if you guys do want to change, so on your KW platform, all right, there is your profile. All right, there you go. Oh, yours perked up. Yeah, so. All right, so there's a profile, and on the profile, there's actually a link on there that'll say visit my website. All right, so if I go to, I'll show this, the one I always like to use, because I don't have a profile. Agent/Lori Godfrey. This keyboard, it's fantastic. You can just press down on everything. And then I can't type at all. All right, so as you can see, let me zoom in real quick. All right, so there is a visit my website link. Now, if you guys are like, yeah, I want to use this website now, or hey, I just haven't purchased a custom domain, I'm going to move that over, so I want to update this. All right, so there is a section on here where you can update this link for your website. All right, and then there's also a section in the back end where you can update your marketing material to display your new website URL. All right, so whenever you send out any email campaigns, whenever you create any type of marketing pieces, at the very bottom, it's going to have your marketing URL, and you probably want it to be the new website if you're going to utilize that. All right, I'm upset because this was actually, that was the girl's account that I was going to log into, and I think she changed her password on me again. I'm tempted to try the other password. All right, but as you can see, here's that blog, and then here is the other testimonial on my homepage. Scott was subpar to mediocre from John Smith. The best part is you have to manually type these in. So if you, one person contacted me on the subject, and they said, I have a testimonial, and it's riddled with spelling errors. I don't want to post it. And I said, okay, don't. And then they said, no, I want to put it out there. Am I allowed to change it? And I was like, yeah, if it's riddled with spelling errors, fix it. And I was like, I would have done that easily. So just an FYI, if someone gives you like a 6-paragraph testimonial, condense it. Yeah, feel free to paraphrase. All right, you don't have to put everything out there. If all of a sudden they go on a rant about how you did fantastic with their children or something, that's where you're like, this has nothing to do with buying or selling a home. All right, if it was daycare, that'd be a completely different story, but it's not. All right, so we're going to go back to our MyKW homepage. It's a weird noise. I'm going to try one more time with a different password. Huzzah. Changed it back to the old one. Can't get away from me. Crazy. All right, so we're going to go back to our MyKW homepage. We're going to click the plus sign of My Marketing, and we're going to go back to our all-time favorite Manage E-Agency website. All right, so if you guys want to change out, or even if you just want to follow along and see where to change it out, so whenever you are ready to update this, you can go. Text them up. Hopefully something fun. All right, so, oh, it fell again. I'm so sorry. All right, so we're going to click on Manage E-Agency website. All right, once we do that, then we're going to select 2.0 on the left-hand side for design your website. So 2.0 on the left-hand side and 2.4 for edit site info. Now I'm going to click on both of these because it'll actually highlight it as to where we went to. All right, so it's going to make it red, right, where it says 2.0 design your website, and then 2.4 for edit site info. You highlighted in orange. Yes, ma'am. Why not? Okay. Yep, so 2.0 for design your website, 2.4 for edit site info.
Okay.
Information. I don't think it tastes very good. Just throw that one out there. It tastes like octopus. I've never had octopus before, but there's ink inside them, so I can only imagine that's what it's going to taste like. All right. I'll put it on my to-do in Idaho list. All right, so when we come down here, there's going to be an option under hosting. All right, so you can scroll down a little bit and look for that hosting option.
Alternate website.
Bingo. All right, so right underneath hosting, it's going to say website to display. And we're going to click the circle dot to the left-hand side of alternate. Sometimes it's right to the left-hand side. Sometimes it's on that second row. Thank you. Or technically the first row.
So did you
on
that again?
So we'll
drop down
to the 2.4.
Mm-hmm.
Yep, 2.4.
Yes, 2.0
and then
2.4.
Yeah, 2.0
and then
2.4. And I just make this the main, my main place your site, not like. Oh, yeah, that's for the image one. But if you want to change it to the other one, you can put it in dot KW. Yeah, so on here, so if you want to display that link to show an alternate website instead of the e-agency one, because obviously this would be a place for us at the alternate, we'd click the circle button. Right, it's the left-hand side of alternate. It might be on that first row. It might be on the second one. And then we'll put inside our alternate website, including the http://. You have to include that, otherwise it won't update properly.
Find the custom one or...
Yes. Yeah, you want to put the custom one.
So what did you do again?
I would still put it though, because then once it is linked, then there's kind of a scroll down. Yeah. Yeah, it's right over here. You click that little circle dot right here. And then right below it for alternate website, you can type inside your entire PlayStore website. Kind of the URL, including that http://.
So this, when I change this alternate website to my new Playster site, then every place that I have this site, is it automatically, or do I have to go into Facebook and everywhere else? And
it'll only be on that profile.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I have to go back to all those places. And
you would still have to go back and update. Yeah.
So it's that website.
So it's not. It's only the place.
So is it a disadvantage just to put your personal website then? You know, like not JoLynnDingus.com instead of the JoLynnDingus.kw, like she was saying.
I would put your custom one, because that's the one that's going to be moved over more likely to your Playster one. So then wherever that is, since that's going to be your main domain, that's the main one you're going to be marketing, so I would keep that over here.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So on here, for instance, like down here, she has http://www.thegodfreyrealestategroup.com. And that goes over to her custom website at thegodfreyrealestategroup.com. All right, so in this case, if you have a custom domain, this is where you can add inside. If not, if you want to use your Playster one, you can put in your Playster URL, including the .kw.com. All right, so it'd be http://john.kw.com.
I'm sorry, where does that go? Right there where it's blue.
So it's under alternate website.
Like once. Yeah, so go right on.
You don't change the thing. Your dot,
yeah,
you don't touch,
yeah,
you don't change that.
Yeah, it's only these two, right?
Yeah.
So you'll select this little dot for alternate website, and then you'll click inside your alternate website right down here. And the alternate website will include that HTTP.
That's my new Playster account.
Correct. Yeah, the new Playster URL.
And then I just moved the dot to your spot. So this is the one I want.
That's correct. Yeah. So if the dot's kind of weird, like it's showing on the screen up here, mine looks weird too. This is actually supposed to be the left-hand side of alternate. It's just not, unfortunately, but that's the one that you want. Yeah, it's kind of weird spacing.
So on Lori's up here on the map, the hosting Lori, that's her KW, and then down the alternative, she used her personal?
Correct, yeah, because these two are actually just for the e-agency website, so we wouldn't want to worry about that. But down here, this is the website that'll display over on the profile. So when you click that view my website or visit my website link, and then this is the URL that it'll take them to.
Yeah,
because once you have that added in, then you just click the save option at the bottom, and this will update.
Just your Keller Williams.
Right. So every place you already have it referenced, the Michelle Williams, Michelle Robinson Real Estate, that you know, that's still out there.
Like on my Facebook
and my Instagram. So the new
Yeah, and that's one of the reasons why I suggest having that custom domain, because then if you ever change your website again, you wouldn't have to update it. It would literally just be move the domain over to the site and you're done.
Right. That is what you're
doing. Now, once you click the save option, this is going to take up to 24 hours for it to update, FYI. All right, so it'll take a little bit of time. If you go to your KW profile directly and you click on the visit my website link, it'll update immediately. If you search on KW.com, and before you go to the profile, you just click on that visit my website link, it won't update until about tomorrow. All right, so it can't take up to about 24 hours to update. You don't have to pay, it's free. I mean, you can if you want to. I'm not going to say no, but no, you don't have to.
I found it easy to just email him, and he emails right back.
Yeah, really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. How many people are in there answering my emails? Because sometimes it's more than one a day.
I'm like, I'm sorry for them.
Yeah.
To be honest, there are 11 people that work at our company.
Yeah.
99% of the emails are answered by me.
Oh, well, that's good, because sometimes I get carried away with myself. Good morning, Scott.
I know who you are.
It's me again.
I know you guys more than you know.
Good.
Yeah. Does that say only right now, like when I'm not? Obviously, because typically, if there's anything that's here's usually what happens. If there's an answer that needs to go back, like if you guys get a response in like a minute or two, it's because I have three screens that are in front of me at all the time. I got a monitor and I got two laptops, and I have on this screen and this screen typically the email, and it pops up and I'm like, email, you got to answer it. So I have that up there. I probably answer about 700 emails a day.
Oh my gosh.
And it's tiring. Well, that's why I'm
always
able to delegate stuff out.
Sources.
Yeah. Exactly, yeah. Well, I get up early. I work a lot of hours. But no, then if it's ever anything that like needs to be done, like a database needs to be imported, I haven't imported a database in like a year. So that's probably from someone else, yeah. Because when you get a response back from support at scottleroymarketing.com, it typically will say who sent it to. Now, we just changed that like 2 weeks ago. So if anything ever comes back and you're like, this was incorrect, I can look back and be like, dude, what happened? Yeah. That was, I know I'm being recorded. So that's that was the nice way of saying it. So, yeah. All right, so that's step one is where we want to change it. So now if I go back over to our profile, we're golden. All right, so now it's going over. Now, of course, if you don't want that link to go over right away, you don't have to. All right, you can take a little bit of time. You can wait. It's perfectly fine. All right, once again, today is June 10th. June, July, August, September. People are wanting to move. They're wanting to buy homes. They're wanting to sell. All right, don't spend 80 hours a week trying to fix up this website. And then all of a sudden, September ends. Green Day calls you. They're telling you to wake up. Nobody. One person. Thank you. All right. Every year, 8 years now, one of my best friends, he was my best man at my wedding. If you go on my Facebook page, you'll see him up there. Every year, October 1st, 12 a.m., I get a text from him that says, wake up. Every year. And it wakes me up. And I'm like, this is insane. All right. So when that's done, and all of a sudden you're done with this, it's now October. The slower season has come in. I don't know if it's slower over here or not. All right. But then all of a sudden you're like, well, I've got this great website. But then all the buyers and sellers I was working with aren't here anymore. Mm-hmm. All right, so don't make this your focal point. Right? That's what I'm trying to tell everyone. You're still going to have those other websites for a good amount of time. They're going to give you a lot of notice when they're going away. The e-agency website is slated to retire at the end of 2016. I highly doubt it will. Right? The main reason I highly doubt it will is because, and I've heard from a lot of people in here, you paid a lot of money to have those fixed up. All right, they look good. I'm not going to lie, they look pretty good. You probably want to keep those or at least have a little bit extra time to move them over. So I'd be really shocked to see if it actually, you know, goes down at the end of 2016. There's no timeline on the EH1. The CRM is going to stay the same. You're literally just getting a new website. All right. I love hearing what some people will say. And I'm like, have you heard anything? Nope. Because they haven't announced anything. And then you just kind of hear all this, the rumor mill. All right. Now, the next thing you want to do, though, is let's go ahead and click on like the link underneath My Marketing where it says new listings on here. Can I do something? It's like you guys get, I love it. I asked earlier this week, I said, cool, ready to go. We got all this stuff. And then the one question I asked was, what am I teaching on? Because I was like, I don't remember. And then they said, yeah, first 3 hours are going to be on this. Second 3 hours are going to be on blogging. First 3 hours on Playstore. I was like, cool, cool, cool. And then I just come in here today. I'm like, all right, we're going to do an hour on blogging. We're just doing like anything else. Can I do a 1 hour, just, you know, throw it out session? Cool. Checks in the mail, buddy.
Yeah. It's your show.
Yeah. Get one more hour of me. Here's the way I'm thinking about it. They told me it was like $15 or so to come see this one act show. I'm telling you, you can't even see the Rangers for $15.
Right.
True. Yeah. It's and that's 3 hours. All right. And they're making millions. All right. I'm making a little bit above minimum wage. All right. So I'm right around there. Oh, by the way. If that had an issue, I'm so sorry. I really thought it was going to go further than it was. They didn't have a
I did.
Oh. Well, yeah, all right. That didn't go nearly as far as I was going to see. Look here, I have another one. I'm sorry. You came in at the end, and I was like, people are unfortunate with these. All right, so we're going to click on new listings on here. And the reason I said let's go off-roading is because we're going to have about an hour. So it's going to be, what issues are you guys having? Let's see if we can fix them. And then hopefully that'll answer other questions.
Can you just tell us, how do we get, I wanted that email signature you said we could get.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah,
she said really quick.
What?
I think that's not really good.
Yeah.
I tried to do it and I can't. You said when I first started with Kelly Williams, I got an email and I tried to follow it and I was just stupid. And now I recruited her, so maybe I should get another email.
Is she going to recruit another person?
No, she's going to follow the instructions.
Okay, cool.
She's going to read it all. And then
gotcha.
I
ask of one thing from you. I'm going to show you how to get to it. I ask that you don't do it until Monday. And the reason I say that is because, A, I'm going to go back and I'm going to look at my email tonight. And I know there's going to be some stuff I'll need to do. So if I see, and you guys are staying in here, so I'm going to show you how to get over to it. I mean, you can get to it at any time, which is the funny part. But then typically I'll send some in the back and be like, hey, did you pay the $10? I didn't see anything. But if you just come in, I'll know that you're from here.
Okay.
If you can wait until Monday, because then I'll be back in the office with three screens. So it'll be fantastic. Because there are a bunch of other people that do email signatures as well. Because you have to have publisher in order do it. I had a water.
There we go. And what I, if you can wait till Monday.
That's good. Got it.
Right. Look at that. Synergy. All right. So we're going to click on the new listings. Go to the top right up here where it says, hi, your name. And we're going to go to my account.
All right. So this is how we're going to change it on our email campaigns and all of our different marketing materials where it'll display our new URL. Now, once again, if you do not want to change this out, you don't have to, but this will at least show you how to change it out whenever you're going to. All right. So we're going to click on hi, our name at the top right. All right. Then we're going to go to my account. Yes, ma'am.
Since you're in EH now, with your website and your marketing and all that, when you were telling me earlier that when you add a name, when you did a delete,
yeah.
If it's not added to your EH, you can do
contact placer.
Okay, that's right.
And then, yeah. Yes. Some other people haven't had that happen either, and some people have. So let them know, because since they're in the launch phase right now, I can only imagine there are certain things that probably won't work. What's going on? Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah.
So on the, I know you guys worked on the MyKW homepage. Could you just click on the real thing?
Then you hit what do you hit? You hit that down arrow?
Cool. Yeah, so once you click on new listings, then we click the top right where it said hire our name. Yep, and then my account.
That's crazy.
All right, so once we click on my account on here, it's going to take us to the back end where we can actually not do anything. All right, so we're going to go back real quick. Go back. All right, and then we're going to click the edit button at the top left up here.
You know, it's funny. Someone asked me one time. Well, I always like to, if you guys, the reason I like to do filler material is because I want to make sure everyone knows how we got to what. So that's why I'm doing a lot of walking around pausing. I'm not just doing this because I'm ADD. I'm sure I am.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah. Someone asked me one time. They got a response back in like, you know, a couple minutes is what I try to do. And they said, they called and they said, yeah, I got this canned response.
Oh.
And I want to know, like, is this correct? And I said, yeah, because I wrote it. So it's like, yeah.
One person asked me one time, they're like, how do you respond so fast? I said, well, you know, you kind of get the same questions after 4 years. So it becomes easier.
Yeah, but I have finally, I didn't even know this existed on Gmail. There are canned responses. I didn't even know that existed until recently.
So now if someone needs to be like set up on, you know, questionnaire or anything, I'm just like, click, done. It sends off. It's great. Yeah, I know. I don't know why I didn't know this. So once I click on the edit button, it'll now change to save. And then right over here on marketing website, this is where you can actually change the URL that will display for you. Oh, you don't have to put HTTP.
Okay.
In fact, I wouldn't even suggest it.
Just the www.
Yes, ma'am. So, and then scroll down just a little bit. You're right there. It's the marketing website. So, on here, the only thing I might suggest is putting inside www.worldwideweb. If you guys get bored tonight, go on YouTube and type in Matthew Perry and Jennifer Aniston. Internet. They did like an internet video back in like 1996. It's one of the best things I've ever seen. I really like it. Just go watch it. That's all I'm going to tell you. That's it. It's your nighttime homework. It's back when Friends was extremely popular.
So up here on the website,
So this is actually just the login that's going to be for the back end of your eEdge website.
Like just the last
one. Yeah, so if you want to change it, you can. I mean, you can delete this, and you can add inside whatever login you'd like to. Since this is linked up with your MyKW platform, I usually kind of tell people don't worry about it. Yeah, because, I mean, you can just go directly into MyKW. The only time that it's ever a little bit bad is that once a year, when all of a sudden like KW servers might mess up and then my KW is just shut down for a day. And then you're like, well, I need to get in the back end. Well, then you would know, but it's one less thing you have to remember username, password wise. That's why I kind of just like, yeah, you're good.
All right. KW Realty, I leave all that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you'll leave everything on there. The only thing you want to worry about for this particular one is just that marketing website. Now you can update anything else that you want to, but this is still going to come from your eEdge CRM. So that's why it still has all the eEdge like KW Realty on it. Heading out? Did you have fun? Okay. I was about to say, that was avoided eye contact when you said that. But that's okay. It's understandable.
If you scroll down, there's like social media options.
Mm-hmm. Oh, yeah, of course. Sorry. So if you do want to add inside social media, that'll display over on this. You can also click the add social media option. Make sure you click save, though, beforehand.
I was just watching online. Did something.
Oh, did I miss that?
I don't know. I'm not sure.
Big brother.
Big brother.
You what? And now I'm back.
Yeah. You know, it's so funny. Like all of a sudden, people leave and you're the only one that comes back. I don't know what that says about you or me, but regardless.
I'll always come back for you, Scott.
Bless you. You're too good to me. I wonder if I clicked the stop sharing instead of the hide by accident.
It was still sharing, but it seemed like it didn't pick up your screen anymore.
Oh, weird. Did it pick up the volume?
Yeah, we got to hear you.
I mean, that's all people want in life. That's it. All right, so whenever you change that, make sure you click the save option on here. All right, and then if you are talking, you were talking about the social media?
Well, like I have things that I don't, like,
blog.kw.com
is my blogger, and I'm like, I don't know.
Nope. Yeah, so you can actually click on add social media links if you want to add in your own on here too. This would display on all of your different eEdge campaigns or your eEdge pieces if you're emailing them out as well. So we're doing kind of a one-hour Q&A of what's messing up.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, so it's worked out pretty well so far.
So how do we go back to the MKW? Yeah.
Do it again?
Yeah.
All right, let's do it. We're going to do it. All right, I was going to do this in our first class because I like to talk. We didn't get a chance for it. All right, so we are actually going to – we were talking about this actually before the class even started. You talk about so many things. I don't know what you're talking about. Yeah. All right, so what we're going to talk about now is actually how to move a custom domain over to your place or website. We're talking – all right, we're going to do this for GoDaddy. Now, you can do it for other things like register.com. All right, you can do it for domain.com. HostGator. You got it fixed.
I did.
No. Well, never mind. I know. You actually, well, you got there, though. That's good. Now we're talking. All right, so what we'll need to do is go back to our place or site. All right, so I'm going to start from the MyKW homepage, and I want you guys to talk me through how to get to my place or site. So where do I go? You're here. All right, where do I need to go?
Technology.
Okay.
Yeah.
Should I click on it? Okay. All right, now what? There you go. All right. If I'm trying to get back over to the domain, we'll go to next. Once it Oh, cool. Yeah, this is on the first one. BB Delta, okay. There we go. All right, so you said, I'd still log in. All right, let me log out of the video. Oh, wrong button. All right. Synergy, man. See, I'm trying to create harmony of Scott. Not always the best. Thank you, Houston. All right, so you say go to view details. And is it scroll down to what? Perfect. All right, so the first thing we want to do is get a custom domain. So we want to add it. Save this real quick. Come back in. I thought that was a cat meme, Ellie. Anyone else hear that too? That high pitch thing?
He's a little kid.
Oh. Cats, goats. No, that's not. All right. So the first thing we're
going to do is have a custom domain on here, including the www. Dot. You don't put that.
Not work. I promise.
Not work. I promise.
Move that right over.
Right over.
Start marketing.
Start marketing. You want to change that?
We're going to. So it'll always have your domain on there, but you'll have a custom domain. I'm going to put inside www.scottleroy.com. And then we'll click add domain on the right.
Do you want to type inside whatever your custom domain has this and then click add domain? At the very
bottom.
It's
not going
to come out. It's on here. Actually, don't click the remove button because you forgot the
Yeah, I need to know our
sites
or
know
our sites.
I don't like to do a list.
Yeah. I know, it's dreadful. I even spoke to HostGator. Cool. Yeah. All right, so once you add it on the
All right, add it in.
All right, so the next thing we're going to do is go to, in this case, GoDaddy. All right, so I'm going to go to GoDaddy.com. All my random domain. I don't have too many. All right, and go ahead and sign into GoDaddy. This is where the magic happens.
You gotta know you gotta have
to go to that. All right, it's either your
Hey, Jimmy.
With NSYNC? NSYNC, Christina? Yeah, Christina, bring us here. Hero spirit.
I can't remember my password to GoDaddy.
That was the most interesting thing ever. All right, so we're going to go to GoDaddy.
I've tried all the traditional ones, and it seems not to work.
Oh, yes. So your GoDaddy? Don't be that person.
Michelle makes fun of me because I have 3 passwords. She's like, have you tried this one? Yeah.
And they just have a dash in between it, so don't worry. I know once you go on GoDaddy.
Manage option number domains.
Oh, I guess it's a username. I'm putting my email address in, and I bet it's a username. I bet that's right. I was putting my email for my username, so my password is probably correct. The one I was thinking of probably works. Yeah. Probably works just
fine. Right, so once you're inside GoDaddy, though, then we're going to find the domain that we want to move over. All right, so in this case, as you can see, you got all my weird ones on here. You ever been to Zazzle before? Zazzle? Yeah. Back in the day. I told you, I had really weird stuff I did back in the day. I have a store on there. It's awful. I'm not going to say the name of it. $200,000 products on it. And I'll randomly get people that will buy stuff. I do like So I get referrals from that. I'm going to smell it all the time. I know, right? I don't think you're supposed to do that, but I renew them each year because they're $15. And like within a month, I make like $35 from them. Done. I'll do that easily. All right. Now, when we go over to our domain, I have the legacy. All right, if you have the legacy one,
your forwarding needs to be turned off, and your main server is on the GoDaddy one.
That's cool.
You're good. You're perfect.
Yeah. That one more time, Scott.
Oh, yeah. Sorry.
So on here, what's my legacy one? All right, but you want to find the name service. You want to make sure the GoDaddy one, right, the stock GoDaddy. All right, and then you do not want anything forward.
If you have forwarding over your EF side, remove it.
All right, so name servers need to be the GoDaddy name servers, and forwarding needs to be turned off. Cool. So now what you want to do is click on the one.
Cool.
And then you'll see why. All right. Now, once you do that, then we're going to go to DNS zone file.
All right. So the name servers are set to the GoDaddy. That's right. The GoDaddy and the Google. That's correct. All right. And our forwarding is turned off. That's correct.
Yeah. All right. So we'll have our forwarding turned off, and we're going to go to DNS zone file.
Will I know if this lead came from that website or from just the regular, you know, if they have two separate names? No.
I haven't seen what it looks like open to the EH platform yet, say the truth. You will be able to see the lead though back into your place yourself.
Okay.
And then you should get an email as well.
What they clicked on to get it, or that they clicked on the place your site's not working. Because this one's taken those. GoDaddy account and moving it into
place,
right?
Bingo. Okay. So that way when you actually go on that domain, it'll take you your place or site. Yeah. All right, so the two things we want to change in the back end of our DNS zone file, all right, now we're talking fancy, all right, is under a host, or sorry, a host, there's going to be an at sign, all right, and we'll want to click this little kind of square on the pencil icon so we can edit it. And once you click on that square and pencil icon, that's what you're going to add inside for where it points to and then the TTL on here. Yes.
You're actually on a different website. Are you on a different website? All right, so on the A host, it says
Yeah, not quite.
All right, so once you click on that, then where you want to point to, it's going to be 184.169.
0.141, 0.142.
Yeah.
Are they supposed to say that too?
Mm-hmm. So it'll say for the A host, it'll say at the at symbol on there. It'll say where it points to. 184.
Because you want this one.
0.169. 0.141. 0.142.
I need to have that written somewhere.
I'm updating our cheat sheet. It's coming out on Monday. I'll be sure to add
it. I've added in all the new Playster stuff. Four new pages of it. That's what happens when you don't have Wi-Fi on the second flight. It was all. I was like, all right, I don't have it. Let's do something. So it worked out.
She had a question right over here.
Yeah.
So you told me to go to standard to go back. Mm-hmm.
Standard and then save option. That might take a couple seconds and then we go.
Oh, that green because there's stuff.
Actually.
Would it work, huh?
Okay, so oh, yeah. Oh, no, it doesn't.
Yeah.
Okay. That's not.
Oh, school. All
okay. So it was. It just keeps showing you the original one here.
Right. And then click those three lines.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Perfect. And then when your domain pops up, go ahead and click on it. Oh. Yep. You're good on here. Click on TMS
file. Yeah. All right. So under at, once again, on A host, it's going to be at 184.169.141.142.
How would you ever know this? So where do you put that in?
How would you know this if you didn't have your students?
Over on here where it says add a custom domain to your site, step by step help articles.
But how about your numbers?
It'll walk you through it.
Where do you put that
at? I just happen to have mine done on here, so I didn't have to take a look at it. All right, and then TTL is going to be 1 hour.
Where do you put that I'm still
Okay, I'm just on the slow boat here.
Don't I have to put in anywhere SheilaLehrman.kw.com?
Not on here.
Not
if you're doing a custom domain. So that would be your actual just KW domain for the website.
Yeah.
But this is if you have a custom domain and you want to kind of use that instead.
Good.
Yeah. Then on here, you wouldn't have to add that inside. There's one extra thing we'll have to add in, then you'll be done.
Okay.
Yeah. But you won't actually have to add it at all.
That's a wonderful
one. Does it matter for your TTL?
Is the 300 the custom one?
No, mine's putting in 600.
Go ahead and change it to 1 hour because that's what they.
Oh, really?
I'm really getting frustrated.
Only lets me change it by the second.
Point. I wrote myself off. Take that off.
And mine's saying it's unavailable because the domains make set name servers don't call.
You're good. No, you're good.
All right, you're right.
There you go. All right, now the last thing we need to do on here is that we're going to scroll down under CNAME. All right, so we're going to scroll down a little bit further, find the one that says CNAME, should be the third one on there, and we're going to look for www.
All right, yours will probably have the at sign.
All right, and once again, we're going to click the little square and pencil icon. All right, so once we're on here, we're going to click that, and you're going to type in what it says right up here, so I don't even worry about clicking on it. It's domains.myrealestateplatform.com. So domains.myrealestateplatform.com.
I'm putting this under where it says points to.
Yes, ma'am. For WWE. Yeah. So,
okay. I'm not sure if I'm keeping
that. If you guys are jotting down stuff, we can also help you out with this too. That's because the name servers haven't done doing quite yet.
Oh, it's only because
of that. Yeah, because it's still showing things.
Does it go updating
until it goes back to the GoDaddy name servers? Do you have the standard ones on here?
It's
WWW.
Wow.
Okay.
Well, I think it might be the same.
All right, and then once you do that and click the save option.
So where do you have to write domains my real estate?
Domains.myrealestateplatform.com.
So can you show us where it went? Goes there.
Mm-hmm.
And take out the at.
Take out the at and put inside domains.myrealestateplatform.com.
Cool.
And put in domains.myrealestateplatform.com. And once you click finish, it typically takes about 15, 30 minutes. If it's coming from a different website, it could take a little bit longer time. Not too long. So if you try right now and search for it, you might be able to get it.
Go to my custom website.
Mm-hmm.
Just open up a new tab and go to that custom website. It's in the website. There you go. Done.
So that's all you have to do.
Yeah, now you don't have to worry about it ever again.
No, that's all
you get. Mm-hmm. And that's pretty much all you'll have to do on here. It's a couple steps, so it's a little bit longer than just forwarding it, unfortunately. But once that's all finished, now if you try going over, it might do it automatically. It might take a little bit of time. All right, so make sure you save it. But now when you try going to your domain directly, as long as everything's set up properly, there's a chance it can automatically pull over for you. So now, oh, so I messed mine up because I got rid of it. Oh, no, it just took me to the back end. There you go. I deleted mine. That's why.
This one is displayed on the homepage.
Yeah.
And then on a separate page, too.
So would that be here across the top then? I should have a thing that says testimonials?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. So I must go to something.
Pages?
Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
All right, so now once you save that, go ahead and try your custom domain real quick and see if it pops up for you. All right, so just go over kind of fast on here. We went to the custom domain and put inside our custom domain by including the www dot. Right. On GoDaddy, our forwarding needs to be nothing. Right. And then our name servers need to be the GoDaddy one. All right. At the top, we clicked on DNS zone file. And the first thing we updated was under the A host, we went to the at sign. And right where it says points to, we changed that to 184. Perfect. Points, so you're going to update that to what's this one right up here. So we changed it to 184.169.141.142. We made the TTL 1 hour. All right, and then click save. All right, and then the final thing that we did on here was under CNAME. For www, we went over to points two and made it domains.myrealestateplatform.com. Well, I'll be seeing all this goods tomorrow. Don't you worry about it.
Check the box on the side. No, ma'am. Just make sure you put the save change after. All right, now once it's all said and done, it can take a little bit of time for it to come over, but go ahead and try. All right, type in your custom domain inside the address bar and see if it pops up with your place, your website.
If it's not, what are we? I'm sure it's
interesting. No, it can just be a title. Yeah. That's good. Perfect. Okay. And then, you can see the cluster back. Just in case it didn't save right away.
So we know it's working when it goes back to.
Mm-hmm. You're good again.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's not fun. Well, hopefully 3 hours go by pretty fast.
And we got up at 5.
Oh my God. Well, 3 hours will be without me talking, so that's 3 hours going to be quiet. So you got that going for it. My ultimate goal is to make you guys leave with a good amount of knowledge. Oh, perfect. Yeah. Did I steal this from you or was this sitting up here? I don't know where I got this from. Okay. And then I just start putting it on my hands. I don't even know whose this is, but I also want to make sure that you guys leave with a good story. That's the main thing. Perfect.
I
would highly suggest that. It can take up to like 24 hours. That should be good.
Okay.
Cool.
So if it's not working by Monday, is that something
about? I would contact, yeah.
Oh, that's the source, just to see what might be going on. Just double check. But you have everything set up properly, so it should be. What?
Just call you.
Yeah, right. Cool. All right, any other questions?
I've got a question.
Yeah.
On this blog thing, I wanted to see how to put an image of like a house on
okay.
the blog I just posted.
Okay, cool. Yeah.
Can I catch you that after class on that? Or?
No, we can do it right now. Okay. All right, so if you're under the blog on here, All right, so you have your blog post pulled up. Are you still editing it right now?
No, I just got it right here and it says no image available. I was gonna see how I
can. Oh, got you. Okay, cool. All right, so hop back to the back end of your Placer site. Okay. And then click on blog post. Were you able to add the testimonials page?
I think so.
Cool. All right, and once you click on the blog post, then you can select edit for the blog that you're looking to edit.
Okay.
Perfect. And the one thing that you want to update on there is the featured image. So if you scroll down, all the way down under the options excerpt, you can choose the file for featured image.
Okay, I can do that.
Yeah,
gotcha.
And then just make sure you click that save button at the bottom to save everything. Yeah. Any other questions or anything? Yeah, what's up?
The beauty is he works for our office.
Oh, do you know where your custom domain is located? Oh,
no, that's correct. Yeah. Those are customers. Oh, gosh.
Okay.
So this is only if you purchase a customer domain. But if you just have that one, then you're good to go. That's all we're doing.
Okay. Did you just have a listening recently?
Oh, yeah.
No problem. Also, let me just do that.
And I apologize.
Thank you.
Everyone's leaving right now, and I forgot to show you guys this.
No, that's okay.
Whoops. ScottLeRoyMarketing.com/email-signature. Scroll to the very, very bottom, and that's where you can actually fill out for your free signature. And a Facebook thing.
Very, very bottom.
They're not the fanciest.
I know. I have
to show you. Gotcha. So right now, it's implemented in KWLS7. So it's not linked up with your IDX point yet.
We turned in all of our forms.
They've already sent them on.
Oh, gosh, okay. It might not be the reason
I told them to call back on Monday and let them know if they got their stuff. It's not the word marketing.
Where you said,
right, and then he said,
yeah, scroll. Oh, sorry. Yeah, scottleroymarketing.com/email-signature. You can hover over templates as well.
Okay.
You go to email so signature.
Download the template.
Okay. Not download, but scroll all the way down the bottom. There are only three that are available, but if you scroll all the way down the bottom, then there's a form to fill out.
And let's fill out the form.
Not quite yet, just because this is actually the KWLS one. But once they officially kind of market your
group,
then we can add that MLS ID for you, and then it'll populate your listings right away. They haven't activated it quite yet, so we're not able to move that over. We just kind of have to wait until they activate it, and then we'll be able to add it. Right now, it's missing, we won't be able to. We have to wait for marketing to activate.
You don't know if you're daddy or not.
That I don't know. It usually takes about 2 or 3 weeks, but I'm not sure. You know,
I don't know.
Yeah,
I'll watch it quick. I need to do a video with a reminder.
Scott, you don't want us to fill this out until Monday, or you want us to?
No, no, no.
Okay.
Oh, you say not your mouth?
Yeah.
Is this what he wants us to do? Wait till Monday then?
Yes.
The email signature?
Yeah.
So you can get her all, and then they can do an email. That you then forward back tomorrow. Because they won't talk to you. So, yeah. So we're gonna have you call. Yeah, Monday or Tuesday, either way. We'll just have to call over there. And you can, if you send
me
an email, or talk to her,
and then say, hey, let's
she can get one call.
There you go.
Yeah, well, I've been usually, yeah, it's so funny. We have like 30 minutes.
Well, on your website, it's not on the list, and I'll see it the next class.
Yeah.
Well, you can build your own eventually.
Yeah, right.
If you're clever enough, you could just download and build
it. If you have a publisher, that's all.
Well, I do. Yeah, I do. That won't come. Oh, I do too. I have to go to the basement where it's cold. That new listing doesn't. Is that what it stands for? Yes. Okay. So, because I have to do ads for a newsletter. Oh, gotcha. Thank you so much. No, you're fine. That's what I'm here for.
Oh, that can be changed too. You can get like your own logo. That's usually what happens. At the very bottom, there's an option to put like your logo. Nine times out of ten, we'll send this off. We send the publisher file and the JPEG file. Well, but then usually they don't have a publisher or any contact rights. It changes. I'm never going to say no. I think you guys have realized that by now.
If you're on your PW homepage.
I didn't, but thanks. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Our intention is never to. There's a lot of companies that'll just be like, hey, here's your JPEG. You want something done, you got to pay for it. And I'm like, I don't want to do it. Here it is. Just take it.
Yeah, because if they have the ability to do it themselves,
they'd rather do it. Well, plus, if they have a contact, we don't keep those on file. So if they ever contact, I look through my safe folder, I'm like, here to download.
Yep. You and I sat here and I said, all the numbers, you have to do the same thing because it's a little, you have to do it right here. You enter the letter because I have not.
It's like, what?
Piece of cake. I don't know about that. Piece of cake. Study the state more than the national. You'll be know the terms. You're good.
Know the terms.
No problem. I'm glad you got the last.
I'm sure you'll hear from me. Like,
that's what I'm here for.
A lot.
I was supposed to.
So.
Hearing from people keeps you in business.
Well, good.
That's what I was
talking. That's
good. Yeah, right.
Uh-huh.
Job security.
Yeah.
You were really fantastic.
The more. Thank you. That's
all right. It was fun and engaging, and for the less than technically savvy.
Well, it's 6 hours of like freaking driver to end. So, I mean, at the end of the day, I feel like a defensive driver teacher. So, I'm like, either have to make a comedy show or it's not going to work.
Plus, I would have loved to take your jungle team, right? Let's just do that for just a minute. You just, I'll close my eyes and you.
Just, you know, that's what the last
time. You've got 10 minutes. Right?
Yeah.
Come on, let's go.
I don't remember it. I'm not gonna lie. I didn't think anyone would bring it up. Welcome aboard. Get out. That's it.
If I have a custom mural barn that I'm going to phase out.
Can you get rid of the Earl?
Yeah, and then I'm gonna.
That's great. I was wondering why you had that. I didn't say it. That's awesome. It's good.
I know, that's what I thought.
That's really good, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
So is this general, so eventually, is there a way to make this old one just forward straight to this new?
Yeah. Whenever it's over, just click on like side of a perfect tone today. Perfect tone.com.
I have a big scratch on the top of my name.
What you don't have found, you
stuck my hand in it.
If you're going to use this one, it's free, then you can't see the other one if you're not paying for something. That'll help out.
Much more fun when you can, you know, answer a question.
So how long do you get? It's going to be there when they start getting
used. Well, it doesn't, if you're...
I guess so, and I just got three emails that three market teams are signing up.
So that's all.
I get random texts from people. I send the picture of Gil, but I just respond with that. I'm like, shut up, tell me something. No, so I've got one day, and I'm going to tell them tomorrow. So they're like, it's weird. I said, where do I need to go? I don't know. I want to explore. It'd be cool. So,
well,
oh, is it? Oh, cool. Yeah. I mean, they have guys who know this.
Yes, old people.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Which
there's more guys.
Yeah.
That's a big one.
Well, it's in reality. Yeah. Those are sort of guys.
That's cool.
You have less pressure.
So did you know that actually it was
more? Which is connected to Yellowstone,
which is the same with Dropbox, but it's in Google. And it's, you know, that's why we don't want the earthquakes here. It's a big caldera.
Now this geyser, it's just, it's a, you know, it's not, you know, man-made or whatever.
No, it's naturally going to come out all around.
And they can predict it. It almost goes up like every
hour.
Oh, because
they're like someone controlling. Okay. It's connected to the sort of spring geyser.
Oh,
they're connected. They're
That's awesome.
Go to Yellowstone, stay on the pasture, and leave the animals alone.
Really?
Yeah, we've lost two people already. They got in the water. Don't do that. Stay on the path. Don't touch the animals.
I think that's kind of what everything
your car.
Is.
It says that.
Didn't that last tourist like put the buffaloes in their car?
Yeah. And put a little
yes, and they had to put it down. I saw that.
Yeah.
Don't
feed them. You'll get sick. They will not place to those. And they send out all the training that happens. That area. I'm okay. I'm good. Scott, are you good with your plate? I'm taking it. Unless you want your fortune. Do you want your fortune?
Can I see you real quick? I just want to knock
it
out of
your
hand. Is that what you did? Oh. All right. Yeah, I'd like to
go
see
it. Yeah.
Right, the least I can do is help you pick up all this stuff. Do you guys typically, there's probably a button actually to do this, is there? There's a button to roll this up, isn't there?
We leave them down. They're always down.
Awesome. So what'd you think?
It was awesome. It was great.
Pretty sweet?
Yeah.
That's all we need to know.
Mine doesn't, unless you delete it or
move
it, it doesn't delete it. It just stays right here. Now, I
create folders. It's a lengthy day. So, as long as their attentions are kept, they learn something.
That's
a good
right.
day.
Like keeping the attention of toddlers.
The longer the better.
Oh, how this started using Gmail.
We've been using mine.
Yeah, it really helps. It's got a lot of upgrades. So I go over here and I hit more. And you can add labels.
That's how I
and so I can move them. And it's like, so I file them. Just drag it. So if I can just drag it. So if I go over here, like, here's my, you know, the business centers or whatever. So this is.
That's how I feel most of my days.
So let's just.
Well, exactly. It always increases. But I remember it's just like when I worked over at these ad agencies, I hated it because I was like, this sucks. I don't want to be here. And I was like, I don't want disgruntled employees.
Yeah.
How old is he?
He's 15.
Oh, cool.
So I'm like, oh no.
Hey, you know what? My first job was at a snow cone stand. It was heaven.
He's got a couple of laundry. That's good for now.
Yeah. You're going to find out it'll take you 30 seconds.
Yeah,
if you know Dropbox, you know Dropbox. It's the same. It's just run by Google.
So I can figure out how to go and get the programs.
Redundantly uploading to Dropbox, then putting it to Dotloop,
and we're just constantly going.
So how many are uploading on Dropbox when that would do this works?
Because it's on our phone, like if I'm out, I don't know, that's why we're trying to figure out, like if we can't find an easy way to get to download.
You know, you have a, oh, you have an Android, don't you? Your beta testing out of an app right now.
Well, are they?
They have one for Apple.
They do.
Oh, they do.
They just
Because we just haven't figured out, we're like, we don't know how to get from going to our Gmail.
Yeah.
How do I get a document that just came into our email account to .loop without downloading it to Dropbox, then I take it to .loop.
There is one way.
It's like the biggest waste.
Well, you, if you'll come to the .loop class, they'll show you how to email right in the
chat.
And it's an attachment, you'll use it right in the chat.
Okay.
Unless you just create your user.loop inbox, which is.
And there's lots of .loop tutorials.
.loop TV on YouTube is amazing. On YouTube, .loop TV is all of their tutorials.
Oh, really?
Yep. There's 3 to 4 minute videos on there. Emailing in TV on YouTube.
Everyone's getting one today.
I'll show you.
Should I follow the class?
Of course.
So you know, if I go to YouTube, but this is ours. If you go, it's in ours. But you just go to, even if you just type dot loop, it'll come up.
Okay.
Dot loop. I didn't go down the TV.
See, I'm like, oh, that smell. I'm just like, oh, that smells great. I love it.
Yeah. See, it's a little, isn't it? It's sickness. So it looks like this.
I'm like, yeah, it smells good.
So dot loop TV. So videos. Oh, I don't know. Don't go videos. I like to go videos instead of all of them. We'll scroll down to the bottom, and they have.
Are you ready? No.
They take off each of the videos.
Yeah, there you go. Sorry.
I know that they have a list of. Like just all the agent training ones.
Is this a screensaver? No.
But you can just do.
You should change the background.
You're going to figure it out. Past webinars. That's
what it wants.
But I was actually thinking of changing the background. It's something else. It's
interesting. Hold on. Hold on.
That's a cool clock you guys had over there, Flatman.
That is cool.
You don't notice anything until you tell me for the first time.
Email or upload.
I didn't even tell anyone where to find knockoff Ray-Bans.
Thank you so much.
Thank you
very much. Have a nice group call.
Oh, I'm going to.
Of course, yeah.
And
it
is.
How's
that sound? I got you covered.
Where it was headed.
Are these both trash cans or motorcycle?
They're both trash cans.
All right.
Well,
then
don't
put
that.
Yeah, we
go to
KWREI training. It's too much.
Ioffer.com.
Ioffer.com?
$8.
KWREI.
And they look like Ray-Ban. You go to Ray-Ban Kids.
And I have playlists.
It's made in China. Telling you. Balling on a budget.
My husband is. He found this app. It's called Wish.
Oh, yeah.
And it's all.
It is, yeah.
And he loves it. I swear, every, like at least twice a week we get a package in the mail that he ordered.
It's amazing. They come in like, especially it takes like 3 weeks to come in. This one's like a couple days.
Yeah, it's nice. Yeah, we're always having China packages in the mail.
Yeah, is it going like that weird packaging stuff too? Yep.
Yeah.
It's not normal.
It's not.
The ones I always get are wrapped it like crazy. I think it's $1 for these 20 ounce ones. I never see that anymore.
We have cans upstairs that are only 60 cents.
I usually see it's $1 for 16 ounces.
Oh, yeah.
And then it's like 75 cents for cans.
Where can I dot lids? Someone bring in those lids for.
It's in here. Oh, I'm going to find it for you. Now I'm mad. I used to have a dot
lid.
I wonder if it's like. I used to have a load more.
Oh, you put
H2. Not loop how to.
Oh, there you go.
Right. So I did all of those are in there.
Okay.
At the very, very high.
I go to your
yeah, go to my KWREI training.
Oh, well, awesome.
KWREI training. Go to playlists, and the very last one is not loop how to.
Okay.
I've done some videos. I pulled out loop videos in.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, so these are your pictures. so you gotta upload and you gotta put them all in there.
Okay. And that's it.
And then you can do that. And then within 24 hours, you'll be out on 365 websites.
Oh, no, everything upstairs. And they're not, you should protect your own inbound, but it's so tight. Nobody's getting, I mean, none of the sellers are getting any other stuff out unless people are doing kind of illegal, which seems, and so some people are kind of breaking the loop rules and giving Zillow and Trulia information, but then they get kicked back from them on their listings.
But so this allows you to control the information, send it out, and you're the listing agent on it, and it puts you in front of everything. So.
Okay.
Yep. And as soon as you're done, you're in.
And it does go out, it feeds out to Zillow.
It feeds out to 365 websites.
And all of them.
And what it does is it makes sure the listing agent gets every gets the leads. So because before, you have to pay your name and your face on there. Keller Williams has negotiated that all the Keller agents are at the top. It has listing agent with your picture and your phone number. People are still underneath you, but the listing agents at the top without any cost. Because we don't like every lead should go to a listing agent.
Thank you guys. Hopefully that was helpful.
So we were gonna put these in, and not that we have on the other list.
Yes,
but Mike's doing stuff in there with the
us in the. Oh, he's bringing the test.
Yeah, so I don't know if we just want to leave him here for now, and then we'll just, and I think, I don't know if the orange cord is Holly's.
Yes, these are Holly's.
Okay. I knew this one was, but I wasn't sure if the orange cord was or not. So we'll just leave those here for now, and then we can slide them in there.
And I think we need to put on our list, figuring out, get a new one of these, why that's, why it doesn't work. And it was, it drove a few people crazy, but it didn't make a difference to me. That it would zzz, zzz.
Oh, yeah. And she was like,
yeah. I think Scott saw that it was driving a few people nuts because